Let me invite Mr. Tarek Fatah to the Madhav's group. This is a small group, sir, of Scindia old boys, and we've just gathered here to hear you out on issues that we've outlined, and I hope that they are also to your liking, those and your agreement. And I'll be passing on the I'll be switching it off to Indra Mohan Singh, who will be the moderator of this event. And IMS, could you please take
actually,
it over now?
Before IMS, Bura, do you want to quickly in 1 minute give a little background about our school so that he knows Scindia school hai kya cheez?
Sir, we are all from Scindia school, and we got around 12 houses there. तो हमारा एक माधव हाउस है जिसके हम सब ओल्ड बॉय हैं एंड सिंधिया स्कूल इज ऑलमोस्ट नाउ दिस ईयर आई थिंक वील कंप्लीट 123 इयर्स. दिस स्टार्टेड एज अ सरदार स्कूल, मतलब मराठों का जो यहाँ सिंधियाज का सरदार थे उनके लिए था. बाद में ये कन्वर्ट हो गया सिंधिया स्कूल में एंड दिस इज इन ग्वालियर. ग्वालियर इज three hours from Delhi, near Agra, 1 hour from Agra.
Absolutely. I've been to Gwalior.
It's on a fort. It's on a fort. Gwalior Fort is beautiful. It's one of the jewels of the forts in India. So then we are from Madhav House. I think that's enough.
Yeah, I think that's good enough.
Gwalior is enough.
Now I'll pass it over to Inder Mohan Singh Malhotra, who's the moderator.
No, before that, Amitabh, you should please introduce yourself.
Sir, Adab, Amitabh Malhotra, मेरा नाम है और इस ग्रुप के अंदर मेरे फादर भी हैं, जो भी Scindia स्कूल के मुझसे सीनियर हैं, वो हैं यहाँ पे. तो हम दो जेनरेशन हैं स्कूल से और हम सबको अपने स्कूल का बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग कनेक्ट है. मैं बम्बई में रहता हूँ. Or thank you for making yourself available. I'll keep it short here right now. And IMS, on to you.
Tarek Fatah Sahab, first of all, let me just tell you how important and how cherished you are for us. And how much we cherish this interaction with you, sir.
You distinguished humbled me. Thank Tarek you so much.
Let me just give a brief, very brief introduction and a biodata, which is generally the done thing at these events. Tarek Fatah Sahab, eminent speaker from several dioceses across the world, was born to immigrant parents in Karachi who had migrated from Bombay. I hope I'm right about that.
Yes, yes.
His alma mater is Karachi University. He was a professional television and print journalist from Pakistan earlier on and started his politics as a leftist while still a student and was imprisoned twice. For those who don't know, he was charged with sedition and barred from journalism under Ziaul Haq's regime. He settled in Saudi Arabia, escaping from Pakistan before becoming a Canadian citizen in
1987.
Okay. Right. He often asserts that he is an Indian born in Pakistan and a Punjabi born in Islam, which is a wonderful quote from you, sir. I am one of Salman Rushdie's many midnight children. That is what he writes about himself. Snatched from the cradle of a great civilization, marvelous words. And made refugees for life in search of an oasis that turned out to be just a mirage. These are lovely words, sir. Very, very impressive. And they define you. And they define many of us who went through partition and who became refugees. On March 31, 2009, he received the Donner Canadian Foundation Prize for his authorship. The book is called Chasing a Mirage. The next book that is very impressive is The Jew is Not My Enemy, unveiling the myths that fuel Muslim anti-Semitism. It won the Helen and Stanwine Canadian Book Award. the television program, which he presents these days with great aplomb, that I personally like the best and enjoy very much, is What the Fatah, regularly carried by YouTube. So that is the, that's the brief intro I wanted to give.
Thank you so much.
Now, sir, I mean, we'll be very comfortable, you know, if we lapse into Hindi and Urdu, if this is okay with you. Because many of the boys might find their questioning, you know, much more convenient in Hindi. So, if you allow that.
Certainly.
So, So let us come to the first subject, sir. Is Turkey becoming the new Pakistan? That's the question. And these are just, by the way, just small points.
Yes, I understand.
We are very, very obliged to Rishi Kishore here, who set this up with you. He's a very industrious fellow, and he's a valued member of our group. And it'll surprise you a little bit about this, about Scindians, because Scindians are a very close-knit community. Even though I'm 65 years old, and there is, like Amitabh Malhotra just said, his father's there, he obviously is very, very senior to me. There are even more senior people, but we have bonded by a strange glue that we are ourselves unable to define. Scindians are a very close fraternity, sir. Okay, so the first one.
Yeah. I have a question for you. What is the root word for Scindia? Is that
let me tell you a brief snippet, you know, very in just a single sentence.
Yes.
There was a general, Mahaji Shinde, who fought alongside the Maratha war, you know, the Battle of Panipat against Abdali with Sadashiv Rao Bhau. And Sadashiv Rao Bhau was martyred in that war with Abdali. But Mahaji Shinde established the Gwalior dynasty. It was a royal dynasty which was actually established by Mahaji Shinde.
Okay.
The current torch bearer is a person and chairman of the board of directors of the Scindia school is a person called Jyotiraditya Scindia. He's the chairman of the board currently. He is Madhav Scindia's son, only son. So he's there.
And they were sent by Shivaji. They were sent by Shivaji.
Yes, they were.
And the name Scindia is like Scindians of India.
Let me just correct you. The Peshwas sent them. It was the Peshwas.
Okay.
Shivaji was actually already gone many, many years ago, before the Battle of Panipat actually occurred between the Marathas and the Abdalis. Anyway. So let us come to, is Turkey becoming the new Pakistan?
See, Turkey is not becoming the new Pakistan. Pakistan is becoming a concubine of Turkey. Turkey has always, in recent medieval past, the Arabs have not had sovereignty over themselves. Since the year 1258, when the Mongols destroyed the Abbasid Caliphate in Baghdad, and which you'll be surprised to know, the Abbasids then got refuge in Hindustan. The Bhawalpur state is where they set up their Abbasi enclave, which later joined Pakistan at the time of partition. That's as a side note. But Pakistanis are a unique people in which you can categorize them primarily to the Punjabi-speaking Muslims and the UP, Bihar, Bhopal, Hyderabad-speaking, Urdu-speaking people who are known as Mahajirs. These are the two groups that claim to be Pakistanis. The Sindhi or the Baloch, or earlier the Bengali or the Pashtun, they never considered other than as a slogan being Pakistan. So when we talk of Pakistan, we essentially be talking people with a serious inferiority complex and identity crisis. Firstly, in Punjab, where the Punjabis themselves banished the Punjabi language and made it illegal in any school of Punjab as a way to determine that they were better Muslims. If they spoke or taught their children Punjabi, they would be considered kuffar because the Sikhs and the Hindus speak Punjabi. So it's a very strange phenomena which predates partition. So for example, Faiz Ahmed Faiz never wrote a single word in Punjabi. Iqbal, although his nani was Sikh, his grandfather was Hindu, they never ever wrote a single word in Punjabi. They would rather write in Persian. And this is quite common in all the literature of the Muslims of Punjab. Their pride in saying that we are not the Fitemu people, we are enlightened, we can speak Urdu, even though when they speak Urdu, half the world laughs at them because the Punjabi pronunciation of Urdu is the most hilarious. When a Pashtun or a Bengali
speaks Urdu,
it sounds, you know, as an accent. But when the Punjabi speaks Urdu, it seems that it's someone on crutches who has lost one of them. So he just bangles on, "Ma kehta hoon ke ye Pakistan zindabad," you know. They can't even pronounce Pakistan, by the way. So these are the two groups. The Urdu-speaking Mahajirs, who created Pakistan, fought for Pakistan, and then divided, went to the place that did not want Pakistan. This category of people control the mindset and the cultural narrative of what is today Pakistan. And their single biggest identity is that they are not Indians. That Kurukshetra has got nothing to do with them. That Lahore or Love or Kakesh has no Indus River, to hell with it. They have no links to the soil. They look at themselves as leftover Turks. And by Turks, I mean Central Asian Turks, because what Turkey is today is also not Turkey. This is what was done by the Seljuks when they invaded the pagan areas of Turkey and established the empire that ruled the Muslim world for 600 years. So Turkey's secularism was quite a painful process for India's Muslims. Now, I'll just take you back that at a time when the Turks were saying we do not want the Islamic Caliphate, the Indian Muslims, unfortunately led by Mahatma Gandhi, launched the Khilafat movement. They were more loyal than the king. Ataturk was said, "To hell with you guys. I don't want Islamic rule. I want a secular, modern nation state in which religion doesn't play a part." What did the Indian Pakistani Muslims of this area, primarily northern India, say? They said, "No, we want the caliphate." And what did they do in return? You know about the Kerala, Mopla rebellion, in which thousands of or hundreds of Hindus were killed because Turkey lost the war, the First World War. Hindus in Kerala got killed. So you see how warped the mindset of the typical North Indian Muslim is. Their association is with fantasy land, far away, of a language they cannot speak, of a people who they have contempt for. People from our part of the world, the Arabs or the Iranians and the Turks. Thukte nahi hum pe. Wo Hindi ya ek aur word kya kehte hain, siyah, Farsi mein kehte hain. They have absolutely contempt for us. Toilet mein aap chale jayen, piche Turk aapke piche dusre toilet mein jata hai. I've been there, I've seen all this. Yet the identity of Pakistan finds itself rooted in a TV serial that is nowadays running. Combine that with that fascist dictator and Taimur of our times, which is Erdogan. he has wiped clean, that school of thought has, the Kurds, the Armenian genocide. After that, hundreds of thousands of Armenians were killed, many of them taking refuge in Calcutta, by the way. They had to run for their lives. They are in Beirut, everywhere. They're dispersed. So Turkey is not taking the place of Pakistan. Pakistan has become, as I say, wo ghar ki londiya jo hoti hai na, wo ke aaj bitiya paise aaye hain Turki se. So you have to understand that this Pakistani mindset has lost its dignity. So they are willing to go with anyone who will give them money. If I can recall the earliest part of Pakistan's history, Hyderabad was not yet part of India, but they were the main financiers of the Pakistan movement. And at that time, the so-called Governor General of Pakistan, which is Muhammad Ali Jinnah, can you imagine, he didn't become Prime Minister. He became Governor General because he asked, kis ohde pe zyada maal aur shohrat milti? Unhone kaha, Governor General to saab, Queen ka hota. Unhone kaha, phir main Governor General. So they begged for money from the United States for $1 million because the Pakistan government couldn't function. The Americans sent them a check of $10,000. They're my bap. They joined the Western camp. If you remember CETO and CENTO, which were America's agents to thwart the Soviet Union and surround India, Pakistan joined both the Southeast Asian Treaty Organization by virtue of East Pakistan being next to Burma and all that, and CENTO, which was Iran, Turkey, and Pakistan, earlier known as the Baghdad Pact. After the revolution in Iraq, where King Faisal was overthrown, it became CENTO. Iraq left. Throughout this, as a way, the Americans used Pakistan as a buffer state to control the spread of the Reds from the north. Pakistan has played that role. Aur aadat pad gayi hai unko, ke they don't find any moral compulsion to stand on their own dignity and space. They consider it quite non-offensive. के पैसे लेके काम कर देते हैं, कभी चीन हमारा बाप है, कभी ईरान, कभी सऊदी अरेबिया, कभी अमेरिका. यू विल फाइंड देयर इज नो रिग्रेट, देयर इज नो नथिंग बीइंग अशेम्ड ऑफ. मेनी कंट्रीज समटाइम्स रन आउट ऑफ मनी एंड दे आस्क फॉर लोन्स, बट यू डोंट गो अराउंड बीटिंग योर चेस्ट, ओ वी गेट खैरात, यू नो. बट दीस पीपल डू, एंड यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट. Up because Turkey is part of the Grand Alliance against Arab countries, and the Arabs have started recognizing that these Pakistanis are very are mercenaries. Inki army Saudi Arabia mein 20-25,000 to hamesha hoti hai. They are not dependable. They are simply there to run away with whatever money the generals can get from Pakistan and disappear. It's the only country where military chiefs never stay back in their own country. They go to Australia or Canada or America, settle down over there. So the Saudis under Crown Prince MBS have recognized that this is like a leech. So they've cut off contact. And because of that, Pakistan has now become a twin, has twin parents of China and Turkey. Turkey se wo apni moral authority aur apni identity establish karte hain aur Chin se paisa le rahe hain. Na Turkey inko respect karta hai aur na Chin. China mein to ye halat hai ki, well, I can't go on TV and talk about this, but people who go on low budget tourism to China, you will tell you stories of how they get rejected, how the Chinese language has incorporated words of contempt for Pakistanis. Yahan se China ki wo jo hain jails, they are now set up in Pakistan. So the prison population becomes free labor for Chinese contractors who are building it. So the country is already sold. Balochistan, it's a nightmare what is happening over there. And Turkey is the spiritual father as such. Turkey ke maamle mein ye hai ke Turkey inko kuch bhi na de to ye unke gulam rahenge. Kyunki ye apne aap ko Hindustani nahi samajhte hain. Hindustan mein rehke to kya hashar ho gaya? Identity crisis, uske upar moral authority.
How is the collective psyche of an entire nation, how has it become so warped? Let me make a very small submission here. Punjab was a kingdom of Maharaja Ranjit Singh and remained under the British yoke for less than one century. The rest of India was dominated by the British for more than 200 years.
Yes.
But Punjab was under British dominion for less than 100 years. And it had a solid, very solid character. Mm-hmm. How come the entire psyche of a nation has become so warped? Can you just put some light on that?
Dev, ki kehna, jo aap apni maa boli ko nahi maane, wo maa ko kya maanega?
I see.
This is fundamental. People, UNESCO, UNICEF, jiski baat kare, children devoid of their mother tongue can never develop. Second reason, children born out of first cousin marriages over 50 generations will have physiological serious consequences. This may surprise you, but most marriages in Punjab or Pakistan and other parts as well, most of the Muslim world, take place among cousins with varying degrees of age. Something that nobody else in this world does. Aapko main agar statistic batau, and you can check it up, Britain mein Pakistani population hai 3%. But it is 18% of the mentally and physically handicapped people. There are multiple reasons for this tragedy that has occurred. This phenomena, ke chachazad behen, kal meri biwi, jo mera mamu hai, wo mera abba bhi hai. Yet this phenomena is laughable and tragic at the same time. Iska kya ilaaj hoga? Jab tak
very despicable, sir. Very obnoxious.
No, sir, this is destroying us physically, mentally, intellectually. Only one group of people are marrying first cousins. Nowhere else.
Can you throw a little light on the original question as well?
Is
Turkey becoming the new Pakistan? I mean, this is a political question.
Okay, no,
it's
Turkey
a political
cannot,
and a sociological.
Okay, Turkey cannot be Pakistan. Nobody can be Pakistan. Turks are quite clear about their ancestry. They're proud about their language. They're proud about their script. They're everything. They are primarily hostile to non-Turkish Muslims.
I see.
600 years, the Turks colonized the Arabs. I digress, but the Arabs have not had sovereignty since 1258. They have not determined their future, their past, their history, their capability ever in the last 700-800 years. And why? Because after that defeat, after the Abbasides went, the doctrine that Arabs are superior to non-Arab Muslims and that any non-Arab who thinks he's equal to an Arab is committing an act of sin within Islam. This is the heritage left behind by a damaged community. Jisko power nahi milne se usne kaha, you don't need to have sovereignty over yourselves. So, ab a person who's a Sayyid and a Qureshi and Hashmi and Zaidi and Naqvi, jo India mein Pakistan mein baitha hua hai, wo kahan ka ho gaya? He's claiming he's Arab. The Arab spits on him. He's called Sayyid. So he's conflicted in an identity. The Turks have no such delusions of grandeur. They are proud of their ancestry, which comes from Central Asia, Turkmenistan, that part. They know that they have fought Europeans, they conquered them, they destroyed the Arabs. They, 600 years, they did not even leave the language where they went. They basically looted North Africa, Saudi Arabia, Hijaz or Najd, the Persian Gulf area, everywhere, right up to Somalia, the Turks. Today, the Turks have influence in the Canadian Parliament. In the United States, the Congresswoman Ayaan Hirsi Ali, who's a Somali. I know of MPs and cabinet ministers in Canada who owe their loyalty, who are not Pakistani anymore. They owe their loyalty to Erdogan. Because, now this seems childish, but that it's true. The Turks are fair-skinned. How could they be wrong? Where do you get Muslims who are fair-skinned and members of NATO who wear suits and pants and ties?
But their things are changing. They're changing.
The things are changing, but they won't. I'll tell you why. Because this, the elections that will take place, you can only have dictatorships for one time. One credit you have to give to Pakistanis, when Pakistan was included Bengal as well, the number of military dictatorships that Pakistanis overthrew is the world's highest. Ayub Khan, Yahya Khan, Ziaul Haq, Musharraf, everyone has been thrown over and told to get out. Oh, phir bhi, now you have such levels of high corruption in Pakistan that you've heard of that General Bajwa having hundreds of millions of dollars worth of investments in four countries outside, and he's been caught. But that's a separate matter. Turks will not let this happen. And I'll tell you why. Turkey has two distinct populations. On its western side are Muslims who withdrew into Turkey as the Turkish Sultanate got defeated year by year in the Balkan Wars of 1910, 1912, 1913. By the time Sarajevo, Hungary, all these places were part of the Turkish Sultanate, or Kosovo, Serbia, jahan pe bhi aap jayenge, Croatia, Albania, all of these countries. So as the Muslims of the European part started withdrawing into Turkey, it is distinct from the Turkey that is on the eastern part of it, which is highly, I would say, more conservative, more Middle Eastern compared to the Turks who live in Istanbul or on the European side. You can see the distinct difference if you visit there. So it is not that easy. Now that you have Turkey's confrontation with Greece and Egypt, by the way, Cyprus, Greece, and Egypt are on one side, and Turkey is trying to colonize Libya because of its oil. So the Eastern Mediterranean Sea is a confrontation area, and that conflict will make sure that Turkey stays within its roots. And my reading is ultimately Erdogan will be overthrown either in an election or a successful
election. You really think he will be overthrown? He's very strong there, sir.
Sir, strong? You can't say strong nahi ho sakta na koi, sir. Musharraf se strong koi ho sakta. Balochistan mein aap samajhte hain, will the Pakistan army win? Impossible. Time is on our side na. Dekhiye, Taimur ka time limited hai. Buddha ka time limitless hai.
Yes.
Such always rises.
Yes.
It never ends. Guru Nanak ki baat khatam hi nahi ho sakti na.
Yes.
Lekin,
I see your logic, sir.
So, but the truth will rise. Sir, ye toh Hindustan ka wo motto hai.
Yes.
I don't recall the exact Hindi words. Yeah, absolutely. Sir, absolutely. India cannot be defeated simply because India is the truth.
Yes.
Pakistan cannot exist as a country because Pakistan is not the truth. Pakistan is a lie.
Yes.
So this will unravel. Punjab, Pakistan's Punjab will be a landlocked place very soon, inshallah. Because neither Sindh nor Balochistan wants to stay with Pakistan. Balochistan in particularly was an independent country which had embassy in Karachi and relations. Had it not been for betrayal by India's leaders, today Balochistan would have been an ally of India.
Yes.
But your Maulana Abul Kalam Azad.
Indian leaders played a very despicable role.
Nahin, sir. Maulana Abul Kalam Azad is the man who had a very racist view of who are Punjabis and Pashtuns. And he told the Delhi Muslims, kahan ja rahe ho? Can a Muslim speak Bangla and still be Muslim or Punjabi? They treated Punjabis like absolute goons. They are so happy all the time. They don't give shairi, you know. Oh, ne ye kaha, Mir sahab ne ye kaha, fulane ne wo kaha, Ghalib ne kaha. No.
So what? One small interjection, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, this is we are learning such a lot from you, but there is also an agenda to follow that Rishi had initially laid out.
Go ahead.
So, there's the next topic is implementation of uniform civil code in India, and why is there an Islamic resistance to it? Why do we see an Islamic resistance to implementation of the uniform civil code, sir? What is your view on this? Have you thought about it?
Absolutely. I am astonished at the level of blackmailing power that the Muslim clergy, especially if they are bad looking in appearance, the uglier, the more Islamic. Oh, chote bhai ka pajama and that type of, they have veto power over India. I'm astonished. Nothing in India can happen till some ugly mullah says, achha, theek hai, jaane do. Bijli ka bill 25 crore ka maine rakha hua hai, Delhi ka, masjid ka, lekin main aapko bataunga Islam mein kya hota. Have you visited old Delhi on your own sometime?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Been to Chandni Chowk, Darya Ganj.
No, andar galiyon mein, sir.
I'm sure.
I was there and I wanted to witness the stealing of electricity. I was alone. And I was looking at those wires. I was, because nobody pays the electricity bill, I've been told in old
days. Yes. Yes.
Dadagiri. So you are sitting there.
Yeah.
And the rest of the Hindu and Sikh population is saying, pata nahi ki kar denge. Yaar, disturb na karo. Pagal ho jaange. Can you imagine stopping traffic between Noida and Delhi? I was there. It was like the very people who say burqa pehno were asking their wife, burqa utaro, sadak rakh do. And nobody could catch it. Delhi mein pitai Hinduon ki kar di. Manal mehru de rende do char sote main theek
hoon. Bahut pitai kari hai sahab, inhone bahut pitai kari
hai. Sir, aap kya hai ki India banata hai pappu. बेटे मोटे होते हैं, बेटियां पतली होती हैं, आपने देखा होगा. हर एयरपोर्ट के ट्रांजिट लाउंज में एक इंडियन बच्चा जो लड़का है वो टैं टैं रो ही रहा होता, मोटा होता है इतना सॉलिड. कभी आपने बच्ची को नहीं देखा होगा. द टेरिबल डिसर्विस द इंडियन अपर मिडिल क्लास हैज डन टू दिस कंट्री स्पेशली बाय दैट वुमन, द किटी पार्टी क्लास ऑफ इंडिया इज डिस्पिकेबल. आप देखिए कि यहां anti-China demonstration arrange kiya humne. Usme 20 to kam az kam Tibetan the, 5-6 Pakistani the, aur 10-12 idhar udhar ke Baloch, sab hum Kurd urd le aaye. There was not one Indian. Not one Indian came. Woh isi chakkar mein aur kar rahe, tarakki nahi ho jayegi, naukri pakki nahi hogi, ye nahi. I cannot understand that the land of India, Bhagat Singh ke bachcho ko kya ho gaya, ke everybody is interested in money. They don't know that you can make money while you are...
1,000 saal ki bhook hai sahab.
Sir, 1,000 saal ki bhook. Arre sir, main aapse keh raha hu, 1,000 saal ki gulami bhi main samajhta hu. लेकिन yes. उनका साथ तो जो वो मुसलमान जो आपके साथ खड़े हैं
इसलिए पैसे की अहमियत है इनके लिए सर
अरे सर
1000 साल की गुलामी
देखिए 3 महीने में ये रिसेशन के अंदर ऊपर वालों ने 20-20 बिलियन डॉलर घर बैठ में बना लिए सर जो कैपिटलिज्म की कंट्रोल है आप जितने एमबीए करने कर लें आप उनके नौकर ही रहेंगे
No,
you are their control. We have a situation where no matter how much we try, Wall Street controls our destiny. Ab Amazon ka owner is recession mein $20 billion kama gaya. Matlab, that means ye khel aur hai. Lekin apni self-respect ke liye to main khada hunga na apne ghar ke samne. ये तो मैं कहूंगा कि आपने हिंदुस्तान को गालियां दी हैं यहां हर कोई देता है और इंडियन ही देते हैं वो इंडियन जो आंटियां बनके बड़े-बड़े वेस्टर्न बातें करती हैं दे राइट इन न्यूयॉर्क टाइम्स एंड वाशिंगटन पोस्ट नॉन इंडियंस नहीं इंडिया के खिलाफ लिख रहे ये क्यों इनसे कोई कह नहीं सकता है कि व्हाट आर यू डूइंग देयर इज नो कंट्रोवर्सी दैट इज टेकिंग प्लेस On this
सस्ते
level,
में बिकते हैं साहब सस्ते में बिक जाते हैं
ये भी नहीं Actually, पता बिकते हैं
पे,
यार ये भी नहीं पता कि बिकते
इन इन दिस कल्चर टुडे अनफॉर्चूनेटली इट हैज बिकम सो डिफॉर्म्ड जेब से ही इज्जत बनती है साहब ये इज्जत का सवाल जैसे आपने कहा ना अपने घर के बाहर खड़ा होगा फॉर सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट यहां पे रिस्पेक्ट जेब आपकी जेब में कितना वजन है हिंदुस्तानी की नजर में वो ही इज्जत This is the situation.
It's very sad. So हमने मुगलों को अपना बादशाह बनाया हुआ है. Can you imagine कि वो मुगले आजम फिल्म पे मरे जा रहे थे लोग? अरे वो सैफुद्दीन वो अपने बेटे का नाम सैफ अली खान ने तैमूर रख दिया. Can you, we are in a crisis stage
yes,
in India.
Yes, look at that.
We don't need to hate anyone. We need to assert our self-respect. मैं अपना नाम बदलता अगर मुझे नहीं पता चला ये तो है ही संस्कृति why are we keeping names of arabs and turks and persians in india कभी किसी तुर्क ने रखा हिंदुस्तानी नाम
तो संजीव नाम का कोई अरब ये जो यूनिफॉर्म सिविल कोड है
हां यूनिफॉर्म
इसका क्या फ्यूचर है साहब आपको लगता
है सर यूनिफॉर्म सिविल कोड विल बी देयर फॉर सिंपल वन रीजन कि ये जो कांग्रेस पार्टी
आपको लगता है ये मोदी साहब ला पाएंगे ये यूनिफॉर्म
एब्सोल्युटली एब्सोल्युटली
ये पॉलिटिकल इशू भी है साहब कुछ पार्टियां हैं यहां ऑपोजिशन की
आई अंडरस्टैंड
जो सेपरेट सिविल कोड्स को सपोर्ट करती
नहीं वो जाएंगी हिस्ट्री में मर जाएंगी देखिए अगर सिंगल सिविल कोड चाहिए आपको यूनिवर्सल नहीं और धर्म के हिसाब से चाहिए तो फिर हिंदू कोड के तहत पूरा हिंदुस्तान रहेगा जो जिसका जन्म और ओरिजिन हिंदुस्तानी है जैन है सिख है हिंदू है बुद्ध है वो चलेगा अगर आपको ज्यादा चाहिए इस्लामी या कैथोलिक तो आप चले जाइए कहीं और मैं एक साइड आई एम नॉट आर्ग्यूइंग दैट पॉइंट दैट
इज विशफुल थिंकिंग नहीं है इस वक्त तो ऐसा लगता है ये बहुत ही स्ट्रांग बीजेपी की सरकार इतनी स्ट्रांग सरकार कभी आई नहीं इन्होंने बहुत सी चीजें इंप्लीमेंट कर दी इन्होंने बहुत से मैनिफेस्टो के अपने पार्ट्स इंप्लीमेंट कर दिए पर ये सिविल कोड को ला सकेंगे या नहीं दैट वाज द क्वेश्चन
आप एक काम करें जिन आपका जैसा ग्रुप है व्हाई डोंट यू गेट टॉक टू मुस्लिम्स हु आर force uniform civil code. Betahasha Musliman, Bachiyan Khas Torpe. The opposition to Muslim personal law should come from Muslims. And there are enough Muslims in India who are fed up with this.
They are fed
nonsense.
Up, but they're not vocal, sir. They are not vocal.
They can if they find if they figure out ki un pe ye ilzam nahi lagega lo ji eh te hinduan de agent ne paise kha le raw to eh ilzam chhad dio na mis 24 ghante mere te eh ilzam hunda te jinab india da agent hai oh india da agent kya I am Indian agent ek agency hai ko ration job kholne mein the point is to attack this with clarity and fundamental laws. The Islamic Muhammadan law is fundamentally against equality of man and woman, promotes slavery, allows for concubines, and it states clearly, marry one, two, three, four, and all that your right hand possesses. That law will be applicable in India over my dead body. And they are going towards that direction. They are not even ashamed that halala is being done over there. I was in Khan Market, two Muslim women in burqa came to me. And you know what they said? Said Tarek sahab, please ye polygamy ke against na bole. So, maine kaha kyun? Kehti hain hum log do teen hote hain to usko sambhal bhi lete hain. अगर एक ही बीवी एक हुई तो वो तो बेचारी पिस जाएगी. कैन यू इमेजिन दिस नोशन. आई वाज ऑस्ट्रक. दे वर लाफिंग अबाउट इट बट दे सेड दैट इफ वी आर टू वाइव्स वी टेक कंट्रोल ऑफ हिम बिकॉज हैड इट बीन जस्ट वाइफ वन वाइफ एंड हस्बैंड ही विल बीट अस अप. जस्ट इमेजिन दैट. And we are allowing polygamy in India. वो एक मौलाना साहब मुझे बोलते हैं साहब एक तो बीवी गांव की होती है और एक शहर की होती है. अरे आई मीन आई यू थिंक यू थिंक दे आर कार्स के एक तो ट्रैक्टर है और दूसरी ये मेरी सुजुकी है. दिस इज डिस्पिकेबल. हाउ कैन इंडिया बी आस्किंग टू बी ऑन द सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल एंड हैव लॉज दैट परमिट इट्स सिटीजन्स to treat women like commodities. Jo log ye kehte hain ke unke kanoon ke tahat anybody who's gay should be killed. Can you allow that law in this day and age to be implemented? Aap kehte hain ke beti ki जो इनहेरिटेंस है दैट विल बी हाफ दैट ऑफ द सन. इज दिस पॉसिबल दैट इंडिया कुड बी अमंग द लीडिंग नेशंस एंड से वेल पार्ट ऑफ अवर पॉपुलेशन इज अ बिट क्रेजी सो वी लेट देम सफर यू नो लाइक द ट्राइबल्स इन अंडमान आइलैंड्स वी डोंट इंटरफेयर इन दैट मैटर. वेल द ट्राइब्स ऑफ अंडमान और निकोबार डू नॉट डिटरमिन व्हाट हैपेंस इन द लोकसभा और डू नॉट वेव पाकिस्तानी फ्लैग्स when the Indian team is losing. So the issue primarily goes to Muslim personal law pe. It's a more fundamental question. What it is to be an Indian. And by India, it is one civilization that's at least 5,000 years old, which created the lettering system, that created chess, that created carved temples out of mountains, not the other way around.
Yes.
We have created religions.
Yes.
We have created Buddha. We have created Nanak. We have created people who came and went. Our civilization spreads from right across Asia, right up to Vietnam. Chola dynasty ko batao to sahi ki the longest dynasty in all of human history. The Cholas went right up across to Indonesia, Bali, it sab kuch forge leke thodi gaye. Apni soch, apni buddhi, your intellect, your mathematics, your understanding of the सोलर सिस्टम, इतनी पुरानी सिविलाइजेशन को आपने कहते नहीं साहब मुस्लिम फॉर्सिंग लॉ चलेगा, नहीं चलेगा, खत्म.
Now, do you think it will be implemented, the uniform civil code? What are your thoughts on that? Do you think it's coming?
It's coming. It will be implemented. But as the Gita says, do not have expectations. Your right is to do, not to expect. So, ye jo hame justuju hoti hai na ki hamari zindagi mein kuch dekh le hum. No. Hamari duty hai to do. And not to have any expectation. वो अगले जन्म में हो जाएगी, अगले generation में हो जाएगी, वो कोई और उसका beneficiary होगा. Our duty on earth is to do. I don't know the exact Hindi, but मैंने जो पढ़ा है, it is a profound line from the Gita. And yet we are impatient.
थोड़ा सा अगले सब्जेक्ट पे भी चले जाएं.
जी जी जरूर. एब्सोल्युटली सर, स्टॉप मी इफ आई एम ट्रैवलिंग टू मच.
थैंक यू सो मच सर, सो मैग्नानिमस ऑफ यू सर. ग्लोबल अनरेस्ट एंड द इस्लामिक एक्सट्रीमिज्म कनेक्ट विद इट. व्हाट आर योर थॉट्स ऑन द इस्लामिक एक्सट्रीमिज्म कनेक्ट with the current turmoil and the global unrest?
There are two factors. Dekhiye, you have to understand ke duniya bhar mein after 1990 jab cold war khatam ho gayi and there was no competition, socialism communism on one side and American capitalism on the other, uske baad khulli chutti big capital ko hui hai. आप देखिए कि वही लोग जो $15 एन आवर मिनिमम वेज को कहते हैं दिस विल डिस्ट्रॉय द कंट्री, वो $25-30 billion को कहते हैं वेल ही वाज स्मार्ट सो ही डिजर्व्स इट. सो द टर्मोइल दैट वी सी इज अ कंप्लीट लॉस ऑफ राइट्स फॉर पीपल एट द लोअर लेवल. अब देखिए ये जब हुआ हिंदुस्तान में भी हुआ COVID-19, what was shocking is that there were people walking to their villages for thousands of miles. Compare that with the same citizen of the same country, all they had to do, others, was to simply lock the door. This contrast that was not possible in the minds of those who have education and enlightenment was simply allowed. Similarly, in the United States, entire cities, people are living from paycheck to paycheck. ऐसे ही नहीं सेनेटर सैंडर्स की पॉपुलैरिटी इतनी ज्यादा थी. Now, what is happening is that this crisis of people not having rights, economic rights, and finding that anti-Americanism as part of their movement has been taken over by the mullahs. And I'm not talking apne Indian Pakistani mullah. It's taken over by people who were born in the West, who follow the Muslim Brotherhood, who are educated, who speak 3-4 languages. And instead of coming out of it as educated people, they come out of those universities as radical Muslim Brotherhood, jihadis, and well equipped to interfere with the system. If you study the fact that on the American Congress Hill, they say there are 400 Pakistanis working there among the staff. Now, in Canada, where I stand, there was one female MP, a Pakistani from the same line, who introduced a law in which you cannot criticize anything that is associated with Islam. It is a criminal offense. So in the parliament, ek jagah Khalistani baithe hain, dusri jagah Musliman Pakistani baithe hain. They are controlling that. They control the what is determined to be terrorism or not. Ab aap dekhiye ke kal America mein do log arrest hue hain for trying to help out Hamas. People have mentioned the names of the white men who were involved, but dusri side pe Hamas wale ka naam nahi aap le sakte. So what has happened is ke international jo turmoil hai uski conditions hain. We today have multiple crises. China ne jo duniya ko beda gark kar diya ek
yes.
Just one I call it biological warfare.
Yes, it is.
Right?
Yes.
Aap sochiye ke China ki nazar Hindustan pe kyun hai? He wants access to the sea. Pakistan ke through bhi hai. Har jagah people are being exploited and are living in third world in wretched poverty. Aur usme phir aapka Muslim Brotherhood ka padha likha ladka jaake kehta hai, brother, this is because of America. To jo jisko main kehta hu Sharia Bolshevism. Jab Ayatollah Khomeini ne takhta ulta aur ईरान के अंदर तबाही आई, आपके सीपीआई और सीपीएम दोनों ने बड़ा वेलकम किया उसे. आप नोटिस करेंगे कि इंडिया में भी जो कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी है वो बिकम्स द बिगेस्ट डिफेंडर ऑफ इस्लामिक एक्सट्रीमिज्म. इट्स कंफाउंडिंग. वो लोग जिन्होंने कम्युनिस्टों को टांग टांग के मारा है अफगानिस्तान में, पाकिस्तान में, यू नो, दहरिया करके, काफिर कहके हर लेफ्टिस्ट को टांगा है, वो ही लेफ्टिस्ट आज एसोसिएटेड है विद द इस्लामिस्ट मूवमेंट अराउंड द वर्ल्ड, विच बाय द वे इज बेस्ड इन पाकिस्तान. ये लोग नहीं समझते हैं कि खालिद शेख मोहम्मद द ब्रेन चाइल्ड ऑफ 9/11 इज अ पाकिस्तानी. वो उसामा बिन लादिन पे सब लगे हुए. अरे भाई, वो तो जिसने स्ट्रक्चर किया पूरा चीज, वो तो पाकिस्तानी था. वो आज ग्वांटानामो बे में बैठा हुआ है. उस तक को आप अमेरिका के अंदर भी आप देखिए प्रेशर ये था कि इस दफा उन्होंने कहा 9/11 पे वो दो बत्तियां नहीं जलेंगी. ये कहां से आते हैं प्रेशर? 9/11 जहां हुआ उन्होंने कहा यहां मस्जिद बनाओ. यू माइट नॉट रिमेंबर दिस. But the attempts at infiltration and forming the public the narrative. Ab Senator Sanders ka campaign manager Pakistani. Senator Sanders ka campaign chair Khalistani. Ab bataiye. Ab mujhe bataiye kasar kya bachi? Abhi bhi, jo American elections ho rahe hain. उसमें वो लिंडा सरसूर हैं, एक एक्टिविस्ट हिजाबी हैं. शी द कैंपेन हैड टू अपोलोजाइज टू हर क्योंकि लोगों ने कहा भैया ये निकाब वाले हिजाब वाले के साथ देखे गए, मर गए तुम. तो दे हैड टू अपोलोजाइज टू हर दैट दैट स्लीपी जो डिडंट वांट टू बी सीन विद हर. बट आप पहुंच तो देखिए कि you have done nothing and yet you want to be right there. How was it possible for a Pakistani to run Senator Sanders' campaign? Jo America ka, aap ye sochiye ki 1960 se activist raha hai, imandar hai, straight hai. I really love the fellow. But he was blind to this. He went and spoke at the Islamic Society of North America and then refused to address the APEC, jo American Israeli kuch hai setup. Who may put the pressure on him? Ek hijabi ladki dekhte mar jate hain gore. Arre baap re baap, multiculturalism aa gaya, tolerance aa gaya. Main aaj ka subah ka akhbar dekh raha hu Toronto Star mein, main tasveer akhbar mein hai a hijabi mother with two children. Koi kisi ne to kaha hoga ki ye tasveer lagao. साड़ी वाली की तो तस्वीर आ ही नहीं सकती. आप कभी आप अंदाजा लगाइए कि कभी मुमकिन है कि साड़ी का पल्लो बांध के कोई बांग्लादेशी औरत की तस्वीर को वेस्ट में लगाए. नो, इट विल बी द इजिप्शियन मुस्लिम ब्रदरहुड हिजाब, दुपट्टा नहीं, हिजाब. हिजाब जिसका कोई ताल्लुक इस्लाम से नहीं कुछ नहीं है ये इजिप्शियन ये बिजेंटिनियन एम्पायर और ज़ोरास्ट्रियंस की वो पहना करती थी तो इन्फिल्ट्रेशन आपका सवाल था कहां तक है आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट इफ नॉट टोटल कंट्रोल देयर इज पार्शियल कंट्रोल which comes from the word I use is white guilt ke unko ye rehta ki hum hame ko racist na keh de hain to isliye hum ye blacks ko to samajh mein nahi aati baat musalmanon ko pata hai ki ye card khelna hai humne jaise hi usne gadbad kiya aapne kaha ye to racist hai khatam ho gayi uski zindagi ab kaun bachayega usse politically so they have manufactured this It can be countered only by other Muslims who can see through. But we can't do anything. Because everybody has to face the risk that uske muh pe acid phek diya jayega. Ya uski beti pe. To Hindustan mein hua na Kashmir mein.
Yes, yes.
Aap sochiye ki ek side pe ek argument kar raha hai. Dusre side pe you're risking death.
Yes.
Or
yes.
damage or Who's going to step forward?
Sab, aap jahan rehte hain Canada mein, Canada mein halaat kaise hain? How is your security in Canada? I mean, the place of your residence.
No, main dekhen ji, I know one thing that Canada mein ye zyada टेररिज्म नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि यहाँ स्लीपिंग जो सेल्स हैं इनके वो बैठे हुए हैं कि अमेरिका इज द मेन प्लेस अगर मुझे कुछ कर दिया तो कुछ तो इंक्वायरी होगी ना तो पकड़े तो जाएंगे ना नेटवर्क पूरा तो मैं तो खुद जाके इंटरसेक्शन है क्लोज में बिल्कुल डाउनटाउन में रहता हूँ और जाके बैठ के देखता हूँ बुरके वालियां बिकिनी वालियां सब आ रही जा रही होती देख रहा हूँ तो दुनिया से तमाशा
Moving on to the fourth topic, sir.
Yes, sir.
It is how do you see the future of India-Pakistan? You know, the present and the future. You know, now that there is a problem with China also, China has come quite openly and quite strongly, stronger yes. than ever before since 1962. Yes. How do you see the future of India and Pakistan? The present and the future.
Yes, I strongly believe in the laws of science and physics, even in their application to the development of history and politics. Pakistan was never a country and will never be a country. Because there has never been a country based on abbreviations or acronyms. So Pakistan is a state of mind, yes. it is not a state. ये जो है कि P चुन लिया पंजाब का और A अफगानिया का और बंगाल तो था ही नहीं पाकिस्तान में चौधरी रहमत अली ने नाम रखा पाकिस्तान का और बाद में पता चला इसमें तो बंगाल है ही नहीं कहीं बी आता ही नहीं है लोग इनको बंगस्तान बनाने देते हैं बट इमेजिन आपको अगर याद हो ना हो एक कंट्री होता था यूएआर यूनाइटेड अरब रिपब्लिक नहीं है ना अब वो था इजिप्ट
हाँ
ओके आपका एक कंट्री होता था यूएसएसआर
yes.
ये जो अब्रीविएशन वाले हैंडबुक पे कागज पे बनते ना मुल्क जिनकी तारीख क्लर्क्स बनाते हैं या डेस्क इंटेलेक्चुअल्स बनाते हैं कि उनकी रिदम ठीक हो वो नहीं रहते सर ईस्ट टिमोर पे 400 साल तो पोर्चुगीज ने हुकूमत की और उसके बाद फिर इंडोनेशिया ने लेकिन आजाद तो हुआ ना टिमोर एंड में मजे की बात ये है कि 100% कैथोलिक पॉपुलेशन का पहला लीडर जो था उसका नाम था कतरी वो ही वाज फ्रॉम कतर एंड रेबल फाइटर अगेंस्ट द पोर्चुगीज इन मोजम्बिक he came Frelimo mein aur jaake, the irony is amazing. Pehla banda dhunda Musalman. But it, because they were from the same struggle, happened. Countries cannot exist without a history or a foundation. Aap 20 manzila building bana ke without basement, without foundation, kitne din rakhenge?
Ji ji.
Ye mekano aata tha hamare zamane mein, ek khel main banata tha. To jab tak uska platform pe screw tight nahi karte the, jo bhi aap banayenge wo toot jayega.
Wo toot jayega.
Iska to koi platform hi nahi hai sir. ये तो इसके जो मेन पॉपुलेशन है पाकिस्तान की पंजाबियों की, वो तो पाकिस्तान कह भी नहीं सकते, वो पाकिस्तान कहते
हैं. ये बड़ा बड़ा गहरा पॉइंट है आपका साहब.
दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी नॉट पॉइंट.
इट्स अ फॉल्स कंट्री.
इट्स अ फॉल्स एंटिटी. ये होगा ये कि आप चाहें या ना चाहें, आपकी सॉवरेंटी गिलगित बल्तिस्तान पे जो है वो आप जो मिस्टेक आपने इंडिया ने की कारगिल वॉर में कि पाकिस्तानी फौज भाग गई, आपके सामने खुला मैदान था अफगानिस्तान तक, तो आपके किसी बंदे ने कह दिया कि लाइन ऑफ कंट्रोल क्रॉस नहीं करें प्लीज. ये जो आपके बाबू आपने भरे ना को 25 करोड़ टट्टू जो बैठे मिनिस्ट्री एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स में और डिफेंस में इधर उधर, तो तबाह कर दिया. यू हैड स्ट्रेट एक्सेस टू फिनिश इट ऑफ वंस एंड फॉर ऑल. बट इंडियन एयरफोर्स वो कह रहे हैं लाइन ऑफ कंट्रोल ना क्रॉस करें. भाई उधर है ही कोई नहीं, वो अपने फौजियों को छोड़ के भाग गए.
स्केयर्ड ऑफ द बॉम्ब. इट्स द बॉम्ब स्केयर.
अरे सर कोई अच्छा निकलेगा ना करके देखें सर. कब तक गुलामों की जिंदगी गुजारेंगे? आपकी टेरिटरी है. आप ये तो कर सकते हैं कि पाकिस्तान को डिक्लेयर करें एज अ स्टेट स्पॉन्सर ऑफ टेरर एंड ब्रेक ऑफ ऑल कमर्शियल रिलेशंस. नहीं कर सकते. एक जो आपकी सबमरीन बॉम्बे में डूबी, अरे उसको जाके कराची पोर्ट में डुबा देते, मुझे ठेका दे देते, मैं करा देता. आई मीन थिंग्स कैन बी डन. बट इफ डी कंपनी कैन फूल ऑल ऑफ इंडिया, हंसने की बात नहीं है.
yes.
ये दाऊद इब्राहिम का घर सबको नजर आ रहा है. इन इंडिया कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग. आपका बंदा वहां फंसा हुआ है, उसको निकाल नहीं आप सकते. मैं दो पाकिस्तानी कर्नल को कहीं से किडनैप करके ले आता हूं नेपाल से, कहते हैं ही नहीं हमारे पास. कुलभूषण को लाइए, बात करेंगे, वरना नहीं करते. ये कैसी, आई डोंट नो दिस एटीट्यूड. इंडिया शुड शो सम वाइटैलिटी. ओ एक टांग ते खड़े होके पंगड़ा नहीं बांध देना हाथ तेरी ते मैन. मतलब ये व्हाट द फक इज हैपनिंग. दे हैव देयर इम्प्रिजनिंग कुलभूषण फॉर नाउ व्हाट 4 इयर्स.
यस.
ओ ओनु किडनैप कीता ईरान तो. व्हाट हैज कुलभूषण गॉट टू डू विद बलूचिस्तान? नथिंग. ही कांट इवन स्पीक दैट लैंग्वेज. बट ही इज इम्प्रिजनड एंड द इंडियंस हैव फॉरगॉटन इट. पकड़ लेना है कर्नल कहीं से. अरे उसको पैसे देंगे हम तुम्हें पकड़ने, वो पैसे ले लेगा आपसे और कहेगा कि मैं पकड़ा हुआ हूं यहां. दिस इज अ वेरी करप्ट कंट्री. इट हैज नो वैल्यू सिस्टम, नो एथिक्स. दे डोंट कांट स्पीक द ट्रूथ. दे हैव नो आइडिया. जिनके प्राइम मिनिस्टर बीवियों के सामने वो सिजदा करते हैं दिन शुरू करने के लिए. आई मीन कैसे कैसे लोग आपके. यू थिंक any civilized country could have Imran Khan in the demos ka naam tha. So when you can end up with a general Bajwa who has kaun sa wo kehte hain papa doc papa kaun se pizza ki chain hai 56 franchises.
yes.
So main to kehta Bajwa burger ban raha hai uska.
yes.
just handle this.
So, by taking एक चीज सर
जी,
बॉयज आर वेरी कीन टू आस्क यू क्वेश्चंस.
प्लीज एनी टाइम.
शुड वी गो इनटू दैट सेशन? शुड वी गो इनटू दैट सेशन
सर? मैं कार बैठा, मैंने की तुसी जिन्ना टाइम लाना है ले लो.
थैंक यू सो मच सर.
या
थैंक यू. यस. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन कम्स फ्रॉम अ बॉय कॉल्ड गोपी अवस्थी हु एक्चुअली लिव्स इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया.
Okay.
He's watching your program. Look at the time zone difference, but it's night time there.
Oh yes.
But he wants to ask a question on Islamophobia.
Ji.
So, Amitabh, can you unmute Gopi and let the question come in?
Aapka hukm sarakho pe, he's unmuted.
Thank you, Amitabh.
You're welcome.
Absolutely delighted and honored to be able to speak to you, sir. And my question to you, without much ado, is what are your thoughts around the growing Islamophobia around the world? And in your view, is it justified? And if I may just say that it's not just got to do with the extreme violence that the world witnesses from time to time, but also in terms of their inability to assimilate in societies, resulting in eventual ghettoization of, you know, wherever they choose to go, such as countries or communities. Also sometimes to a certain extent imposing on other communities and countries where they choose to make a home for themselves. Particularly to a certain extent wanting the communities that host them or the countries that host them to change their ways of life to accommodate their own.
Aapne jawab to de diya hai. You've already answered the question. This is a, by the way, this is a big, address my friend from Australia. This is a big flaw in the Indian methodology of question and answers. Invariably, the questions are rhetorical questions. So I've been at universities right across India where every questionnaire gives me the answer and then asks. So what happens is that instead of the question remaining pure to itself, it becomes convoluted into the Gopiji, it becomes mixed up into the answer and question of the questionnaire. So let me put it where your question ended. What do I think of Islamophobia? If I'm living in a society where I could slaughter a cow and have it for Bakra Eid, then the negative reaction of my neighbors would be justified. And therefore, to institutionalize and defame the guy who's offended by the slaughter, we call it Islamophobia as it is some aspect of racism. No, it's not.
Exactly.
Muslims come in all races. Muslims are total black like Muhammad Ali. Muslims are totally white like the current trend in Western Islamic organizations of putting at their head converts who are white. I've seen that in a number of places. So let race get out of the issue. The point is the term should have been Muslim phobia, but because of hatred getting involved in a rational discussion became Islamophobia. You have a problem with somebody who is conducting himself contrary to the norms of society, right? So, for example, in Canada, they have managed to pressurize local mosques, local municipalities to allow mosques to give their Friday prayers on loudspeakers. At the same time, in the Allahabad, the Supreme Court of India determined that it was not to be done in a society like that. So if people in the neighborhoods of Canada are saying, why are we being disturbed? What is this Allahu Akbar on the loudspeaker?
That's going on in Canada, sir.
Yes, yes. So
I don't think it is there where Gopi lives in Australia.
But no, it will come. Gopi, it will come because we are not fighting.
Yes.
You know, they will come because we are incapable of scientific, rational opposition to irrationality. we succumb to a natural instinct of saying, "Aki, kithon laya hai Musliman nu?" Ye hota. The point is that we have to get and make a rational argument devoid of any hate. Some hatred towards someone, you've lost the war. Wo jo hai Islamic extremist jo azane de raha hai, aap andaaze lagaye 4 baje subah Bhimtal mein main tha, near the Himalayas, and there was azan, and the city has a lake in front of it, so the sound was, and there were only, I think, 700 Muslims living among 6,000 Hindus in Bhimtal.
What a pity.
Huh? I walked from the place. I woke up at 4 o'clock in the morning. My host was saying, "Jane do yaar." I said, "I'm going to go to this mosque and see how many people are there." I walked uphill with trudging along. Masjid gaya, 7 people sitting over there, you know, with their backs to the wall, with their legs pointing. Aye. I said, "You 7 people, you woke up 50,000 people. Why?" Bole na Hindu bade khush hote hain ki hum subah subah utha dete hain hum log. I said, "What world are you living in?" But how do you determine whether it is Muslim phobia or Islamophobia? Right? Let me give you an example. Whenever you talk about Muslims who insist that their religion says something, ask them, who did they marry? Did they follow the Prophet's example? Because the Prophet didn't propose to anyone. His wife Khadija proposed to him, who was twice widowed and was 15 years older to him. So do you know of any Muslim who has ever married a widowed woman who is 15 years her senior as his first wife? No. They tell him, "Shut the F up. This is not about..."
There's a second question, sir. There's another boy.
Yes, certainly.
There's another boy, sir. His name is Piyush Agarwal.
Ji Agarwal.
Who wants to know about the... Piyush Agarwal, who wants to know about the proximity of holy places of these two faiths in India, Hindus and Muslims. I think he should ask the question himself.
Certainly.
Piyush Agarwal, please.
Yes, sir. This is me, Piyush, here. Thank you for your very, very informative lecture, sir. The question is that I consider the two mosques in Mathura and Varanasi, which are, you know, built in the proximity of, you know, some places with Hindus really revere. So to me, they are more of the conquest or the defeat of the Hindu people at that time than being, you know, places of worship for Muslims.
What is the question?
What is your opinion on it?
I do not consider those mosques as mosques by any standard of human existence, human civilization. The two mosques are an insult and an affront to the history of Hindustan. And for them to be placed there in full view, especially the Kashi mosque, where the evidence is staring at us, ke a temple was sort of destroyed and then rebuilt and a mosque came out in front of it. So everyone to see. What shocks me more is that the ability of the Indian governments and the Indian people to tolerate this. I'm serious. No other people on earth would let this happen. Ke Mathura, can you imagine? You build a mosque over the holiest and it is a conquest. Or in sab ko chodo, aapne 70 years you allowed Prayagraj to be called Allahabad.
Yes.
What has Allah got to do with Prayagraj? I often ask, will you allow Makkah to be called Ramraj?
Kumbh hota hai wo. That's a very, very holy place.
Sir, main kumbh kita hai, main haj bhi kita, kumbh bhi kita. I'm the only person on earth that is blessed by waters from both sides. But I'm saying, how is it possible for anyone to tolerate Lodi Gardens in Delhi? If you accepted that Ashoka is secondary to Lodi, because that's how it is. Ashoka ka wo jo statue hai, wo andar hai Lodi Gardens ke. Bajaye iske ke Ashoka Road ho aur wo Lodi ka statue ho upside down, aapne wo kar diya. A man who invaded India is being celebrated. Aur yahan tak ke people like Javed Akhtar defended Khilji.
Yes.
Who destroyed Nalanda? Do you have an internal problem of your own self-respect that you...
That was a wonderful interaction you had with Javed Akhtar. It was an eye-opener. You actually made mincemeat out of it.
Nay, but he was so rude. Even he's a friend of mine.
Very rude.
He won't let me speak. And he was chuckling like a comedian. Hey, yes. That is why I have a dislike for Urdu, because it's me, even when you insult, you look like an intellectual.
Yes. Sir, the third question,
yes.
In fact, there are parts of that question. It should come to you from Amitabh Malhotra.
Ji Malhotra.
Amitabh, please.
Sir, mera sawal seemit hai sirf uniform civil court se, because that occupies my mind a lot more. So,
okay.
आपने काफी उस पे यू शेड सम लाइट ऑन दैट बट माय क्वेश्चन इज दैट इफ यू हैव टू गेट इट थ्रू आपने कहा आएगा फायदा किसी और जनरेशन को होगा लेकिन आपको उसके ऊपर रहना पड़ेगा लेकिन मुझे नहीं पता कि ये कॉमन मिनिमम प्रोग्राम कैसे लाया जाए अब जैसे जीएसटी भी हिंदुस्तान में आया तो परफेक्ट नहीं था बड़ी दिक्कतें हुई लेकिन ओवर द पीरियड उसको आप कर रहे हो उसको जैसा यूनिफॉर्म कर सकते हो चेंज कर सकते हो इसके अंदर प्रॉब्लम क्या है कि अगर मुसलमान ये सोचता है कि उनके लिए बहुत घाटा है यूनिफॉर्म का नाम ही यूनिफॉर्म है वो तो सबकी पर्सनल लॉ हटेंगी और उसमें आएगा तो हाउ डू यू ब्रिंग दैट डिबेट भी तैयार नहीं हो रहा है उसके लिए
यू जस्ट हैव टू इनएक्ट इट 370 के अंदर आपने क्या डिबेट किया
सर पार्लियामेंट तो गए थे ना सर
पार्लियामेंट क्या किया पास किया
जी
लोअर हाउस अपर हाउस खत्म चीखते रहे आप आपने वो जो you will have to risk another one of those kya tha shalimar wo jo baithe hue the khane pak rahe the wahan pe
CAA
can you imagine that you saw that totally illogical irrational it was naked hatred of the Hindu being exhibited as if it was a love for India मुझसे 10 मिनट करा देते खुदा की कसम मैं ना कीमा बना के इन्हें सर्व कर देता इमेजिन दे आर सेइंग दैट दे आर ऑफेंडेड आई एम डाइग्रेसिंग बट द पॉइंट इज इट जस्ट हैज टू बी डन टू डू बिल्कुल लेनिन ने कहा था ना व्हाट इज टू बी डन लिखा था इसी तरह यू हैव टू इनेक्ट इट एंड यू डोंट लुक बैक The people are with this government, otherwise they would have elected somebody else. You know, Shashi Tharoor agar hote Congress mein to shayad threat bhi hota. The current Congress has no vision, nothing at all. I am shocked at the notion that you honored an Italian-born woman as the leader of a party who had nothing to do with India or anything. But her word is the law in Congress, within Congress, right? So, I'm a left of center person, so I might even not vote for BJP if I was there. But the facts remain that a certain national interest should be above politics. You cannot have a country with dual laws. That's apartheid. One country, one law. Khalas. You don't like it? Migrate. Aa jaye Canada mein. Aapko kahin aur jana? Somalia chale jaye. Wahan to 100% Musliman law hi hai. Har kisam ka aapko milega. Khush rahenge aap. So we need to take an aggressive stance. ये defensive batting जैसे वो हमारे एक हनीफ मोहम्मद क्रिकेटर होते थे, वो 18 घंटे में 300 रन बनाया उन्होंने. वेस्ट इंडीज थक के मर गई गर्मी में, आउट ही नहीं हुआ, वो पैडिंग करता रहा, एक रन एक रन एक रन. Someday you will have to come, stand there and long on or long off pe continue छह छक्के जावेद मियादाद वाले आप मारे और फिर बोलें इब की मार. You are not displaying the Maratha and the Rajput spirit that took care of the Mughal oppression in India. You have to understand that these are remnants of Mughal exploitation of Bharat. Ye aapne pehle sultanatein bardasht ki, slave dynasty banai sahab, jo यानी आपको हिकारत से वो देख रहे हैं कि उन्होंने कहा गुलाम हमारे ये चलाएंगे अब. माय गुडनेस, आई इफ आई वाज लिविंग इन इंडिया आई वुड हैव कन्फ्रंटेड दीस पीपल टू देयर फेस. तुम जुम्मे के दिन मस्जिद में दुआ मांगते हो कि या अल्लाह मुसलमानों को फतह नसीब करे कौमुल काफरीन पे, एंड देन यू गो टू द हिंदू एंड से आप काफिर थोड़ी हैं, हम तो वो यहूदियों को कह रहे थे. अरे क्यों झूठ बोल रहे हो, क्यों झूठ बोलते हो, एंड नोबडी इज देयर टू कन्फ्रंट देम. हर आदमी अपना एमबीए के चक्कर में फंसा हुआ. यू नो इंडिया नीड 6 मंथ कंपल्सरी मिलिट्री सर्विस, आके सारे पप्पू जाके फौजियों की बेंचों में सोएं और पता चले कि मुल्क क्या है जिसमें वो पप्पू और पैसे वाले बन रहे हैं या उनकी अम्मियां वो किटी पार्टियां कर रही हैं. दिस हैज डिस्ट्रॉयड इंडिया. यू नीड टू बी लाइक not aggressive, but men with self-respect and women with self-respect. Who tamasha maar ke aaye, halala karoge yahan pe, char biwiyan karoge. You should figure out what is wrong with Muslim personal law and put it up. Do you defend this? If you defend this, one way ticket. Jao. Wo apne Ambedkar sahab ne kaha tha, train bhar bhar ke bhej do unko sab. ये क्या बात हुई, यहां बैठ के पाकिस्तान बनाया, खुद रह गए सब्सिडी के चक्कर में, वहां पाकिस्तान में अब उसका झंडा उठा रहे हैं. बांग्लादेश की स्ट्रगल में आपको पता है कि देयर वर नो इंडियन मुस्लिम सपोर्टिंग द मुक्ति वाहिनी. पूछे किसी से, एक दो डेढ़ साल की जंग में जेनोसाइड में देयर वाज नॉट अ सिंगल इंडियन मुस्लिम हु सपोर्टेड द बांग्लादेशीज. व्हाई? काले हैं, छोटे हैं, अपने तो सैयद लोग चल रहे हैं ना, यूपी में बैठे हुए हम अवध के हैं नवाब. दीज पीपल नीड टू बी कन्फ्रंटेड. अरे कुछ नहीं, खुदा की कसम मैं मुफ्त में आके कन्फ्रंट कर देता हूं उन्हें. बात करें औकात क्या है, ये क्या है, फलाना क्या है, खुदा के वास्ते स्टॉप फूलिंग इंडिया. यू हैव एंड द वे टू दिस विल बी काशी temple, the removal of that mosque in kya hai, Mathura mein hai, wo Lord Krishna ki Mathura mein hai na?
Mathura sir.
Mathura, haan.
Yes.
I've seen both. And mera
khun khol jata. The place is actually called Vrindavan. The place is actually Vrindavan.
Vrindavan, okay, I'm sorry. Yes. But
yeah, you see, Vrindavan.
That is my answer to this. You need to stand up dignity, self-respect, and if you don't respect Indians, ek main aapko baat kahun, then don't expect non-Indians to respect Indians. Some of our behavior towards the less fortunate Indians is terrible in India. Ye to aapko manna honga. So we need to cross those lines, but in the end, the spirit of India will triumph, and Sindh jo hai, wo to milega Hind se. Kyunki सिंध के बिना हिंद मुकम्मल हो ही नहीं सकता. आप नेशनल एंथम में, आई होप आई आंसर दैट क्वेश्चन, दो आई फॉरगेट व्हाट द क्वेश्चन.
अमिताभ, आर यू सैटिस्फाइड?
लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. एब्सोल्युटली, इट वाज गुड एड्रेस, प्लीज.
ओके, डू यू हैव अ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फॉलो?
अबे देयर आर अ बंच ऑफ पीपल हु वांट टू आस्क क्वेश्चन दैट हैव सेड इट. सम पीपल हैव सेंड इट एडवांस.
Let us go to the next person, Uday Naik.
Okay. Just one sec.
Is Uday with us?
Yes, he is there. I'm just going to ask him to unmute himself. Uday, there you go.
Okay.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, Uday, you're on. Please.
Good evening, sir. Good evening. Very simple question. May not be that simple, but even then, billions of dollars have been spent by China and a lot by Pakistan for the CPEC.
Yes.
In the situation today, is it likely that both countries will meet their mutually beneficial objectives?
I don't think so. It is possible because as I suggested earlier, I think in terms of these relations as whether they conform to the laws of science and physics or not. When you are expanding CPEC into a territory that was an independent country and in which there is a war going on with the Pakistan army versus the Baloch, different freedom fighting groups, they are scattered, there's many of them are exiled. It is simply not possible. It cannot get legitimacy. And the latest example of China's failure in Balochistan is that a member of parliament from the Pashtun area, Ahmed Diwar is his name, he landed in Quetta yesterday and got arrested for a Pakistani member of parliament being in Balochistan was considered a crime. And therefore, aap samjhiye ki they are accepting the fact that Balochistan is not part of Pakistan. Otherwise, he couldn't be arrested. Literally, usse kaha visa kahan aapke paas? No, I'm just exaggerating. But this cannot come to fruition. If Punjab came right down to the Indian Ocean, the Pakistani Punjabis would have said, "Theek hai ji, theek hai." Because they have for centuries doing this. Jab bhi fauj aati thi, kehte the, "Delhi udhar hai sir, is there thoda sa tax back de do hamein?" Or darya paar karke chale jao. You never had these great battles in Punjab. It always happened either in the frontier area or in UP. So the point being that CPEC cannot succeed because it will cease to be a commercially viable venture for the Chinese. Pakistan will not be able to repay their loans. And then if China thinks that this is some country like Ethiopia or Eritrea, jahan wo, ya Zambia, where the loans cannot be paid back, to like in Sri Lanka also, they take hold of that island. Well, I'm sorry, Mr. China, but Balochistan is an independent country. They have fought 7 wars. They are currently losing thousands of people to the Pakistan military. Do you think they'll be afraid of the Chinese army when they take over? This is wishful thinking. And partly it has become easy for China because the Baloch are divided into many factions. If today there was a single African National Congress type of a struggle movement, this would have finished by now. If India had a bit of, a bit of conscience, they would have understood that if nothing else, they could supply winter clothing or blankets to the Baloch guerrillas fighting the Pakistan army in Balochistan, but nothing comes from India. These people, so they will not allow China, but fundamentally, China is going to face their Waterloo in Balochistan. Gawadar, they can do anything. They can take away the fisheries. I was seeing the film of a bridge built between Karachi and Balochistan, which is already breaking up because the foundations on which it was standing have been built by the Pakistan military. Therefore, the concrete is not of the right type and the bridge is crumbling now. Itni chori hai ki wahan CPEC aate aate, agar CPEC, even if it is made, it will be absolutely. Don't worry about that. Usse pehle Pakistan, alhamdulillah, ho jayega.
So the next question comes from a boy called Sandeep Tandon. Sandeep Tandon.
Absolutely. Haji, Tandon ji.
Sandeep.
Sandeep ji, kahan?
Is Sandeep there? Okay, the next question comes from Anurag Kejriwal.
Oh, Kejriwal. Oh, good.
Kejriwal.
Kejriwal. I thought Mr. Kejriwal is coming.
No, 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 sir. Ek minute mujhe zara mauka de. Main unko unmute karta hun. Anurag. Sir, Anurag Kejriwal is not in the house. Yeah, so we got to move on. Sandeep Tandon, yeah. I tried to unmute. Just give me. I tried to unmute Sandeep Tandon. He's not. Tandon, I'm going to.
Hello.
Yes, go ahead.
Sandeep just Amitav. Asked you a question.
Yeah.
Amitav.
Yes. Yes. Tandon, go ahead. Ask question. Amitav. Ask your question.
My voice is bad. Can you ask my question?
I can hear your voice. Voice.
We can hear you. We can hear you. Go on.
Ask your question,
voice
please.
Voice is pretty unclear. Can you ask on my behalf?
Are aap pooch lena bhai. Why can't you ask the question?
Sir, his question is,
yeah.
What do you estimate the percentage of Muslims in India to be who want the Sharia law actually implemented in India and who support fundamentalism as compared to those who support reform? What is the future of fundamentalism now? This is the follow-up question. Now right. That the Saudis are giving up on it. Saudis seem to be getting away from
it. Let's go one question at a time. What
yes,
was
sir.
The first question? Sorry.
Sir, the divide, the percentage
first
of...
Was,
yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah. Ask. How many do you think support the Sharia law?
Okay. Let me answer that.
Yeah.
Everybody wants their neighbor to be under Sharia law, not themselves. So, Varna, you will find most Indian Muslims in what is today the Republic of India are dormant sort of folks whose leadership is in the hands of ugly mullahs. And I specify that they're ugly because if you're good looking, you can't become a mullah. So they have very little clue about what is Sharia. And so, out of Muslim nationalism or patriotism, they will go along. Yeah, bilkul, Islamic law, Muhammadan law, hona chahiye. Ye, zara sahab, kaisi baat kar rahe hain aap? It is more pronounced in the three areas, that is Kashmir, Calcutta, West Bengal, and to a sad thing, but Kerala as well.
Yes.
And this notion of Muslim nationalism is the point. I have yet to meet a Muslim who has read the Quran. I'm serious. Wo jab bachpane mein maulvi mar mar ke padhata tha, wo aa jata hai. Kyunki the tragedy of the Quran is that it has been compiled not by chronology but by the size of the chapter, which is absolutely mind-boggling why anybody would do that. And it was not done by the Prophet. This came about around 50 years after. So they have no clue about Sharia, about the Quran, about anything. They do recall and know about hadiths because that is where the mullahs come up with these fascinating accounts of Jannat ki hoor and all that, you know, a bit of sexuality, you know, and power and all that. So the madrasa type guys who've been through that embedded into the belief. They can't think beyond that. But I guess most Indian Muslims are captives of these people. But if you do not know what Sharia is, how can you support or oppose it? Do you know part of the Sharia law is that you have to be so obedient to your husband that if he has a sore with pus pouring out of it, the wife's duty is to lick it. Arun Shori has written an entire book about fatwas from Dioband and Bareilly and all this nonsense. It's in English. It's in Urdu. It's in everyone. So these guys just want to get along. They are like the Muhammad Ali Jinnahs, who, by the way, photograph still adorns Aligarh University.
Yes.
That is the might of the Indian state. Yes. It cannot take out the number one enemy of India from its Aligarh Muslim University. But anyway, ultra-right-wing people will take it down. When rationalists should take it down, because, yes, you know. So the point is, if you don't know what is Sharia, the only thing you are patriotic to is the notion of the Ummah, the Ummat. Ke hum sab ek hain. You should read Maulana Abul Kalam Azad's speech in 1914 in Calcutta, where he says, ke ek musalman ka dil jo hai, wo Cheen ke musalman ke dil ke saath dhadakta hai, aur pata nahi kya kya. Hindustan ka usme zikr hi nahi hai. बिचारे पैदा तो सऊदी अरेबिया में हुए थे, आपके एजुकेशन मिनिस्टर बने, सारी एजुकेशन पॉलिसीज उनके वजह से बनी, इसीलिए पूरे हिंदुस्तान में किसी को राजा दाहिर का नहीं पता कि वो कौन है. द पॉइंट बीइंग दैट दैट वुड नॉट बी द फियर दैट आई हैव दैट हु वांट शरिया एंड हु डजंट वांट, बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द माय co-religionists, uske baare mein kya kehenge, the innocence of the lambs, which film bhi thi, kaun si lambs ki, but there is no leadership. People like General Atta Hasnain, or who do remarkable, I mean, Indians that you can be proud of, they don't have that reach. And those guys who are film stars and all that, I think they are so tied up to the criminal underworld that they can't do anything. So you have the number one most famous Indian Muslim of all times is the man from D Company, who's sitting in Pakistan. Usse bada powerful Musliman to nahi na India mein koi, Dawood Ibrahim se. उसके छोटों के भी नाम है, छोटा ये छोटा वो. One of them tried to get me assassinated in India. Two guys came to kill me. They were arrested there. I think they're still in jail over there. So unless you remove madrasas from the education system and make India into a single public education network, in which the upper middle class and the at least the middle class also send their children. This notion of sending them to top class private schools is dividing India and selling it out to its enemies. The day you have a public education system like we have in Canada, whether you're rich or you're poor, no matter what, it's the same education system for everyone.
Are there any madrasa kind of education institutions in the West, sir?
Yes.
Are there any West,
yes,
Britain,
yes,
and Canada?
Absolutely. And you should meet some of the white converts.
So how would the reform that you're suggesting, it's a very pragmatic and practical reform, but how would this be implemented if even the West is encouraging madrasas?
No, the West is not paying for them.
I see.
West is not paying madrasas to teach this hate.
Right.
But in India,
madrasas have no dearth of funds.
I don't know, but the government of India should stop all that.
Yes.
Why should we be funding people who hate India?
Yes.
Dekhe, the basic tenet of the Islamic faith, non-Sharia Islamic faith, is Ghazwa Hind.
Sab yahan politics badi appeasement ki hua karti thi. Ab cheezein badal rahi hain, par dheere dheere badal rahi hain.
अरे सर, कुछ ना किसी ने कुछ तो करना पड़ेगा. यू कैन नॉट हैव मॉस्क प्रेइंग फॉर गज़वा हिंद.
यस,
कि जब तक हर हिंदू का कत्ल नहीं हो जाएगा और हर हिंदू मुसलमान नहीं होगा, यौम कयामत नहीं आएगी. और यौम कयामत की इंपॉर्टेंस क्यों है कि मुस्लिम्स बिलीव दैट लाइफ बिगिंस आफ्टर डेथ.
यस,
वी डोंट बिलीव दैट दिस इज लाइफ, दिस इज द ट्रांजिट लाउंज. जहां से हमारी अगली कनेक्टिंग फ्लाइट जाएगी, फिर वहां मिलेंगी हूरें।
या तो एक फॉलोअप क्वेश्चन ये था, फॉलोअप क्वेश्चन उसका ये था लड़के का, संदीप, मिस्टर संदीप टंडन, ही इज अ पर्सन फ्रॉम बरेली, व्हाट इज द फ्यूचर ऑफ फंडामेंटलिज्म इन द वर्ल्ड नाउ दैट द सऊदीज आर ग्रेजुअली गिविंग अप ऑन इट? Do you think the Saudis are giving up on it, first of all?
Well, yes, to a certain degree. Dekhe, let me explain what is the situation in Saudi Arabia, which is very unconventional, but it is my analysis. I've lived there 10 years. Saudi Arabia today has women who are mothers of adult children. The women lived and studied in the United States and studied subjects like sociology and history and political science. They didn't study engineering or business administration. So to stay in the United States, and these were from the upper class royalty families, they, the princesses of that time, say in the 70s or 80s, went there and stayed there for about 10, 11, 12 years, came back. Now you have a product of the mothers of people like Prince MBS and Mohammed bin Salman, who are already enlightened to a degree that that passes on to their sons.
Right.
Jab maan anthropology padhi hai, history padhi hai, social science padha hai, to usko pata chal gaya na ki duniya mein hai kya. मौलवी तो नहीं पढ़ा है, हाँ, तो उनके बेटे तो कम से कम अकलमंद पैदा होंगे। I have lived there. Saudis are very smart people. वो पता नहीं ये ड्रेस ऐसा पहनते हैं कि they look strange, but on the average, some of the best Arabs I've met are Saudis. You can sit with them and discuss. I've even met Saudis who were pro-communist. वेस्टर्न एजुकेटेड हर चीज समझ में आ जाती है ना, फिर तो आप पढ़ेंगे ना, पॉलिटिकल साइंस पढ़ रहे हैं तो मार्क्सिज्म थोड़ा बहुत तो पढ़ेंगे आप, लिबरेशन वॉर्स पढ़ेंगे, कॉलोनियलिज्म पढ़ेंगे, आपको पता चलेगा कि टर्की हैज बीन बगरिंग यू अप फॉर 600 इयर्स। सो दीज आर इनलाइटेंड सन्स ऑफ इनलाइटेंड मदर्स। दैट इज व्हाई टुडे इन आई बीन टोल्ड व्हेन यू लैंड इन जेद्दा द इमिग्रेशन ऑफिसर्स आर समटाइम्स वुमेन, the bank officials, women working behind counters, these are Saudi women. They can drive a car, they can have music festivals. Now that is normal human being. Now funding of Islamic extremism comes more from Saudi individuals than the Saudi state. So if you have to give zakat, which is an incredibly enlightened aspect of Islam, that 2.5% of your assets every year have to be given away. And therefore, near Ramadan, when it, this Ramzan, when it has to be done, these Western Pakistani type mullahs start floating like, you know.
I see.
Upar se ke, ओ जी विकेट कीपर तेनु फड़ लेना, डेनिस लिली के 9 स्लिप्स नहीं होते थे, वैसे खड़े होते हैं जी, मिलता नहीं मिलता, एथों पढ़ो एथों पढ़ो। नाउ कतर हैज टेकन ओवर दैट रोल, कतर इज अलाइड विद टर्की, यूएई एंड सऊदी अरेबिया टुडे आर फार अहेड इन द लीडरशिप इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग कि दुनिया है क्या, करना क्या है। इसराइल के साथ डिप्लोमेटिक रिलेशंस करने हैं, 5-6 जंगें लड़ी हैं, हर जंग में 14-14 मुल्क एक मुल्क पे अटैक करता है, वो फिर भी जीत जाते, कि कोई तो सोचता होगा ना कि भाई कैसे हैं, कि क्या करता है इसराइल कि वो जंग जीत जाता है, लाखों की फौज आती है, हथियार डाल देती है। इस पे स्टडी भी हुई भी है कि कंपनी टू कंपनी लेवल द अरब platoon and the Israeli platoon are at the same level of fighting. Jahan officer category aati hai, wahan dabbu log aate hain, kyunki Arab armies ke andar rishtedar hote hain, officers. Pilot jo hai wo chacha zad bhai aur is type ka hai racket. So these are not professional armies. This generation has finally figured out ke kuch zinda bhi rehne ka tarika hota hai. UAE is a shining example of what they did. I am all for a Palestinian state, but UAE ko samajh mein aaya ke Palestinian state to betahasha do ban gayi hai. Hamas is different in Gaza and the Palestinian authorities in the West Bank. All that is complicated, but the funding of Islamic extremism is coming from Qatar and Turkey. The Saudi individuals may be funding, but the Saudi state is not. That's the distinction.
No more. They were the biggest funders
of Pakistan. So, thekedari thi na, they would fund Pakistan, Pakistan would fund the terrorists.
Now, the next question comes from this boy, Kejriwal. Anurag Kejriwal, please.
अगर मिलेंगे तो जरूर उनको मैं ले आऊंगा लेकिन वो है नहीं इस ग्रुप के अंदर
ओके ओके सौरभ प्लीज
एक मिनट सौरभ गुप्ता यस डॉक्टर साहब इज इन द हाउस अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ
यस सर सर गुड इवनिंग सर थैंक यू फॉर योर एनलाइटेंड एंड एनलाइटनिंग टॉक सर माय क्वेश्चन वन यू हैव रेड द कुरान आई होप So, yes, is peaceful coexistence one of the tenets of Islam? Because we don't see that happening around us, somehow, unfortunately.
I don't think that the Quran as such is talking about peaceful coexistence. The Quran is sort of a moral compass to the Arabs of that time as to how to conduct their affairs and how to get out of the rut that they are in, because mind you, even the tiniest Indian town would be under some Raja or Maharaja, and or in China or in Europe, wherever. But imagine this territory of Hijaz had no ruler. Nobody cared about this place. There was no paper, there was no ink, there was nothing, there was never a book written in Arabic. Right? So this area of Najd, and you have to put that in context, Najd and Hijaz that formed Islamic lands at the time of the Holy Prophet. The Prophet never asked for an Islamic state, nor did the Quran ask for an Islamic state. That is the function over here. So what the Quran talks about finding out the non-believers and attacking them and killing them. And then in the next breath, says, I admit they are all there. But they cannot be the basis of state versus state relations in this era of, since the 18th, 19th century. Colonialism died in the 20th century. We're independent countries. We have relations based on the UN Charter and the 1948 Universal Declaration, UN Declaration of Universal Human Rights. That determines our relationship. It is a folly to analyze what the Quran says, because the people who are Islamic fundamentalists, they are not following the Quran, they are following the madrasa teacher. Khalid Sheikh Mohammed, who did 9/11, had no understanding of Islam, neither did Osama bin Laden. Neither did the hijackers. They would rather go for a drink, late night party, than to do it. This is Muslim nationalism. This is Muhammad Ali Jinnah cutting off the limbs of India, and India saying, "Acha, theek hai yaar, phir se uga lenge do haath." We need to be very careful not to get swept into this notion ke ye to Musalman hota hi chor hai. Ya Quran ko jaise kal maine dekha. Some Iranian was tearing papers and spitting on it. And then he started making fun of Hindu deities on internet just to prove that he's an equal hating person. Isse koi fayda nahi hai. We do not have to go to that level, but I'll admit it does not talk of peaceful living with non-Muslims, because it considers non-Muslims as kuffar, who do not believe. Anyone who has a statue in their house is not one of us. Now, if I am to be a citizen of Canada or Pakistan or India, I have to accept that there are people who have mandirs in their basement, or there are people who are atheists, or there are people who are Buddhists. So the debate has to shift whether in the times of a nation state, does a religion apply or not in the making of laws of that country. Laws are only laws if they can be changed. If a law cannot be changed, then it's not a law, it is illegal. Yes, because yes. Every time we pass legislation in parliament, the embedded fact is that the next generation will file an amendment. Yes. Some MP will say, I want to move to, as happened in 370.
Yes.
We are not bound by laws that cannot be changed.
Yes.
We can be bound as a moral compass. Yeah. We can be bound, as Islam says, even if you have to die, you cannot tell the lies. Obviously, 90% of Muslims say, I don't want to follow this law, but I want to eat a cow. Even despite the fact that Muhammad said that cow is not an animal to be eaten. Don't eat it, it will give you madness. It is an animal that gives you milk. Drink the milk. But do you think any Indian Muslim believes that? Of course they believe it, but they know.
It's a very big issue.
Yeah, so they deliberately...
Among Indian Muslims.
Sir, there is no Muslim anywhere in the world that eats a cow.
Yes.
I think
Saudi Arabia mein toh gaye hoti bhi nahi hogi.
Sir, na Afghanistan, na Iran, na Turkey, na Indonesia, na Somalia, kahin nahi koi gaye khata. Punjab
in
mein,
India, beef is a very big issue with Muslims.
Why? Because the Muslims want to rub it in into the Hindu.
Rub it in, yes.
Koi compulsion to nahi hai na? Aap fatwa de dena ki gaye ziba nahi hogi. I dare them to say that. Bakri se kaam nahi chalta.
It's a part of the constitution. It's a part of the directive principles.
I understand, but Sajib,
that is ignored.
Ignored hai na, kyun hai?
Yes.
Ke ye, when you are guided by hatred towards the kuffar, and uska recourse nahi hai hamare paas. Recourse isliye nahi hai ki aapne Lodi Garden banaya hua.
Yes.
Sir, just one more question.
Yes.
Sir, has the community been kept away from education on purpose?
Nahin, sir, education ke liye, to keep someone away from education, you don't need to have compulsion. Aap kisi bachche se puche ki school jana hai ya chutti karni, wo kya chutti karni. The human urge is to stay away as a child. So they have to go, children go get educated. Yahan pe problem ye hai ki what is education? So, you've got this area of Mewat, is it called? Mawat hai? Kya hai? So, UP ke paas hai. Jahan massive illiteracy hai.
Mewat.
It's a majority Muslim sort of area. But the literacy rates are the lowest in India. Now, I am no expert in this area, but I find the lethargy of not going through formal education is a bigger incentive to not get educated than to do this. Ab bachcha ghar aayega, usko padhana bhi padega, usko batana bhi padega, wo sawal puchega. Isse behtar nahi hai na ki bachche ko padhao hi nahi. Na sawal puchega, na kuch karega. पंक्चर लगाएगा खत्म हो गया वो ठीक है गंडेरियां बेचेगा कुछ इस टाइप का और पैसे आने लग जाएंगे देखिए इसमें दो चीजें बड़ी इंटरेस्टिंग है द कम्युनिटीज दैट सेंड द चिल्ड्रन टू स्टार्ट वर्किंग एट एन अर्ली एज आर फ्रॉम द डिप्राइव्ड कम्युनिटीज जो पुअर सेक्शन बट वो लड़का जो 15 साल की उम्र में 100, 200 जितना भी कमा सकता है, he becomes an earning member to the family. अगर वो स्कूल कॉलेज जा रहा है तो he is a negative, उसका negative output है family income से. So there's a built-in incentive for the child in an illiterate माहौल में कि वो जाहिल ही रहे.
To not to study. Yes.
Not to
start
study.
Earning early.
Yeah. So you're just sitting like that, not doing anything. And at some families, people are investing everything they have to get into education. Mm-hmm. You know. So it's a tragedy for India. Yeah. This, whether it's Indian Muslim or not, if an Indian Muslim is suffering, that is our tragedy as well. Because these guys. We are staying in India whether you like it or not. हमारा आपका वो निकाह हुआ है जिसमें तलाक की गुंजाइश नहीं है. So and you can't take a second wife. So पासे जब तक है इसका इलाज ढूंढना पड़ेगा. इसमें comedians जो हैं they are doing a better job. Believe me.
इस group में सब एक doctor हैं.
अच्छा
जी. Very 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 high class doctor. He's a nephrologist.
Okay. Okay.
And he has a very interesting question to ask. Dr. Sanjay Kholte, if you're there, will you come up with your question? Sanjay Kholte. He's a doctor from Nagpur, sir, nephrologist, okay. Surgeon. Done a lot of very good work.
Dr. Sab, how are you?
I'm good, sir. Thank you so much. It's a pleasure listening to you. I salute your clairvoyance. I salute the courage with which you live and carry forward your thoughts. And the group that we all belong to is called as the Common Room.
Yes.
And believe me, the Common Room used to have its maximum glory and fun on Saturday evenings, as it stands today also.
Okay.
So the question, sir, is which has always intrigued me right from childhood, is the failure of assimilation of Muslims amongst the remaining society of our Indians.
Mm-hmm.
I think Dr. Saurabh also said the same thing, coexistence. So whenever a terrorist is caught, we declare him as a misguided youth. So is it fair to declare indoctrinated hardcore terrorists as misguided youth is one question. And what role do parents actually play in this radicalization? Beyond being just complicit in their grooming.
What was the first misguided youth, you said?
Yes.
No, is it fair to term them misguided?
No. They are not misguided. They are very clear.
Yeah.
We are misguided. They have immense clarity in what they are doing, what their objective is, what their purpose is, and why they consider life to start only after death. This is clarity. This is not being misguided.
So I think it's out of fear or out of probably appeasement that they are labeled as misguided youth by the law.
This is what in the West I call white guilt. In India, it is Hindu guilt. To avoid being called a racist or a bigoted or right-wing, alt-right sort of label, people don't want to confront the truth, which is that this guy is a terrorist. He's a jihadi. He considers the death of every Hindu as his birthright. That's his belief system. And this should be, and I doubt very much that parents are involved in this. I think parents are usually the last people to find out that the son or sometimes the daughter is going to run away and join ISIS. The same young girls who are not allowed to go on a date or have a boyfriend have been sent to ISIS to have multiple husbands. Look at the tragedy of the Muslim community. Can you imagine what goes through parents when their sons or daughters are involved in this? It is more, the tragedy is that the more educated the Muslim youth, if he is a nationalist or considers himself above Indian civilization, who considers himself as the representative of the Islamic Ummah, it's a tremendous source of tragedy for the parents. when the children do this. I have not yet seen parents complicit. What I've noticed is that most of these young radical Muslim nationalists that I see in the West, born in the United States, Canada, and Germany, Europe, everywhere, the parents are more secular and open-minded than the kids.
There's a fellow who murdered Daniel Pearl, that yes. famous case of the Wall Street journalist.
Yes, yes.
His
yes,
parents yes. were the last to know.
Yeah.
Abu yes. Yusuf. I think that was Abu Yusuf.
Yes, yes, yes. So that, I don't know.
Yeah.
Why Go ahead, sir. See, your second question, sir.
Why don't we see open condemnation by parents whenever it happens? Parents coming forth and condemning the acts of their kins or their kids.
That's unfair. That's unfair. No parent wants to condemn the children. That is, I think, unfair.
You mean to say the question is unfair?
No. To expect
unfair on the parts of the parents.
Yes, to denounce the children. What a mushkil, highest standard of behavior aapne rakha. Uske dost, us community ke leader denounce kare. Maa baap ne to nahi kiya na. There is no case, I have found nowhere where Khalid Sheikh Mohammed's parents made him into a terrorist. All these guys from Kerala who went to become toilet cleaners for ISIS. By the way, you know that the Indian Muslims who went with ISIS were not supposed to have sex.
Were not the mainline fighters.
No. Not just that. You were not allowed to have sex with anyone who is of Arab origin. That is also Sharia, by the way. So
it's a purity of race issue.
Yeah, so they had, these guys then had to find out non-Arab women to pick to have multiple affairs with them. So they would get a Chechen or somebody, some Bangladesh. somebody will write this era as, conducted by fools, which could have been stopped. Even now it can be stopped. You've got to shut down madrasas in India. Sir, you got to make sure no mullah ever comes on TV. I don't know how. I rarely see Hindu people.
Ek wo 72 huron ki theory hai sir. The 72 virgins they will be waiting.
Arey bhai yahan
aur jo kuch mullahon ne unki descriptions di hain.
I know
virgins ki jo wait kar rahi.
Haan ke 300 foot lambi hongi. Why would I want 300 feet tall? For goodness sake! Are sare 5 feet ki theek.
Sir, IMS, you should take note of the fact that now we are pretty much done. Fateh Sahab has been very generous with his time.
Yeah, there are two main questions remaining.
Okay,
one please. Is from Rajiv Bhatia. Put Rajiv Bhatia on, please.
Ek minute. Acha, I'm just asking him to unmute himself. And Bhatia, be short. Be quick, please. Bhatia, please. Go ahead. Arre, main aapko unmute karta hoon, aap phir apne aapko mute kar lete ho. Bhatia, come on. Ah, okay.
Alex, can you hear me?
Yes, it's not important. Yeah, I think he can hear you. Sir, he can hear you.
Sir, maja aage aapse baat karke, sunke aapko. You said you are leaning from center to left and you won't vote for BJP if you were in India.
Elections.
I agree to that, sir. Mere ko ye bataiye, how do we incubate Muslim leadership in India? Bacche politics mein kaise aayenge musalmanon ke? Nahi to uske bina na madrasa band honge aur na ye radicalism khatam ho jayega, sir.
Kare recruitment. CPI
करती
है। नहीं वैसी साहब को जाने दे, वैसी साहब छोड़ें सर। He gives me the creeps. Point is कि India is a very large country, huge place. आप देखिए कि West Bengal में कैसे जिन मुसलमान फैमिलीज को आप इनकॉर्पोरेट कर सकते थे, जो किसी जमाने में सीपीएम की गवर्नमेंट को सपोर्ट करते थे, वो आज दे आर वहां शरिया इन्फोर्स कर दिया एक विलेज के अंदर. देयर इज समथिंग दैट हैज टू बी डन ऑन अ सोशल लेवल एंड पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज हैव टू डू रिक्रूटमेंट. अब व्हाट आई द इंप्रेशन आई गेट दैट इंडियन पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज people join simply for some notion of getting upgrades, yeah, if they have ambitions to be leaders of some sort. Whereas, I don't know, maybe I'm too old, but at my time, we became members of political parties based on what we thought would provide a solution to the problems that we face in our city or a province or a country. वो सोच खत्म हुई भी वी इन सम वे. आई एम वेरी डिस्टर्ब्ड एट द वे महात्मा गांधी इज मेड फन ऑफ. इंस्टीट्यूशंस लाइक दैट शुड नॉट बी द. सो पॉलिटिकलाइजेशन ऑफ द यूथ शुड बी ऑन इश्यूज. डू वी हैव अ मिनिमम वेज इन इंडिया फॉर एग्जांपल? डू वी हैव 40 आवर वर्क वीक? डू वी हैव How do we do, what do we do with our fisheries? What do we do with the ecology? Green movement kya hai? Kaise karenge? Ye sab issue base hata ke Hindustan mein it has become race and religion based. And that is troubling because India has to lead the world. It has to get into the Security Council, but it cannot get in if all our thoughts are based on race and religion, not ideas. Not philosophies के क्या करना चाहिए या civil disobedience. दुनिया कुछ civil disobedience हिंदुस्तानियों ने सिखाई, यहीं से निकली ना कि गोली खा लेंगे लेकिन जवाब नहीं देंगे. वो उसमें बुरी बात नहीं थी, लेकिन civil disobedience के बाद दो चार मेरे जैसे भी रखे ना साइड पे, जो अपनी सोटी से पिटाई करें किसी की. All it takes is के an approach that should not have anything to do with hatred, that should make a comedy out of these mullahs and those who are trying to denigrate India around the world. Aap dekhiyega ki India ka nuksan jo pahuncha rahe hain log, wo upper middle class ke Hindus hain. This is worth noting, but our animosity towards them is quite subdued. एक मुल्ला यहाँ करता है, दूसरा एक हिंदू न्यूयॉर्क टाइम्स में लिखता है इंडिया के अगेंस्ट, या वो जो उनका तबलीन साहिबा का बेटा है वो तो कितना गड़बड़ इंडिया के अगेंस्ट लिख रहा. सो वी नीड टू हैव
सलमान तासीर
सा कमाल हो गया.
व्हाट इज हिज
या इट्स अनबिलीवेबल.
बट या
आई डोंट हैव ऑल द आंसर्स अनफॉर्चूनेटली. If I was there, I could have.
I missed one thing. So, sir, time ho gaya hai, mujhe pata hai. Now, there are some people who have joined because you have tweeted. They are not part of a school. I am not unmuting them. I'm going to pop two questions which have been raised. I think one okay. of which is a little provocative to provoke you a little bit, but okay. But it's good to kind of put it out there. So, Janab Ahmed Ibrahim Sahab hai, unhone do question puche the, main wo utha leta hu jo thoda sa zyada aapko provoke karne ke liye shayad ho sakta hai, shayad na ho, main maafi chahunga unse.
No, that's okay, fine.
एक उनका है और एक है Brandon साहब, जो Brandon Stark जो बिल्कुल repeatedly fire किए जा रहे हैं वही सवाल. तो Brandon Stark का साहब का सवाल ये है कि यू नो प्लीज एक्सटेंड योर थॉट्स ऑन हाउ मौलाना आजाद डिस्टॉर्टेड इंडियन हिस्ट्री, ये एक उन्होंने पूछा है. और इब्राहिम साहब का ये सवाल है, दो में से मैं एक उठा लेता हूं, कि व्हाई डिड मिस्टर फतेह टेक ओथ टू द मोनार्क व्हिच इज कनाडा सिटीजनशिप ओथ दैट लूटेड इंडिया फॉर 100 इयर्स.
ओके Okay.
दोनों में से आप कोई भी जवाब दे सकते हैं.
No, Brandon has asked a question saying
Maulana Azad.
Maulana Azad. Okay.
How did he distort the history?
Yes, he distorted India, Indian history, by, as the first education minister, by eliminating the entire essence of the 7th century, whether it was Raja Dahir, whether it was Muhammad bin Qasim, or whether it was the Karkota civilization that created, was a very magnificent Indian civilization going from the Caspian Sea to Bangladesh. It's out of it because he didn't want anyone to know that Arabs invaded India. Because Muslims know about Muhammad bin Qasim, Hindus don't know anything about him. In fact, Raja Dahir, the first man to stand up to invasions of India, was eliminated from the textbooks of Indian education system. So that is a simple answer as an example I can give. Then the question to Mr. Ibrahim Sahib ka sawal tha ki why have I taken oath?
Yeah.
Because this is the country that I have chosen to live in. When I come to Canada and the laws say that you have to do such and such, then I will follow the law. Unlike you, sir, who goes to India and then says, okay, I will tell Indians what to believe, that Taimur is a great king. Is that what you mean? I go and give my loyalty to an institution of wisdom, peace, brotherhood, and a success.
Otherwise, why would you be there?
Why would I be there?
Why would I be there? Yes.
Of course, that's my reason. I would love to be in India, but I cannot because I was born in Karachi. So my choice is that I will be at a place where I'm free to talk to you and your sword cannot chop off my head. Now, I'm yes. sure that is very painful for you to understand, but try karein. Someday you might be able to come to my doorstep and do what you really actually want to do, because this is, after all, a transit lounge.
He's responding with a ha-ha. He's responding with a ha-ha. With a very ha-ha. Stupid ha-ha.
Ha-ha. Wo karte rahe na.
Very stupid ha-ha.
हाँ चार चौथी बीवी से पूछ लेना भैया
सर चलिए आगे बढ़ते हैं सर अभी सर अब आपका समय बहुत लिया जा चुका है और अभी भी सवाल खत्म नहीं हो रहे हैं और मुझे बड़ी दिक्कत हो रही है उस सबको इकट्ठा करने में तो सर आप बताएं कि आपके अंदर अभी भी वही जज्बा है जो दो घंटे पहले था जवाब
देने का सर मैं भी जिहादी हूं सर ऐसी बात नहीं
सो आई एम
दो दफा पाकिस्तान के जेल काटे हुए तो ऐसा मसला नहीं है हमको पता है कि क्या होता है
ठीक है सर
तो जो है क्या होती
सर एज ह्यूमन बीइंग्स तारिक फतेह साहब एज ह्यूमन बीइंग्स वी आर एक्सट्रीमली प्राउड ऑफ यू सर
नहीं
एक्सट्रीमली प्राउड ऑफ यू
सर
सर इट्स अ प्लेजर टू इंटरेक्ट विद यू
सर फिर अब मुझे अब I think you need to give Rishi the stage at the end of the day.
Are you the moderator, Amitabh? Are you the moderator?
No,
if you're
I'm
not, please get out of the picture. Let me go with Tarek Fatah sir. Okay. Now, the next question comes from Sarabjit Singh Bura.
Okay.
You know, he has a very simple question coming for you, sir, but quite yes, relevant. So, let Sarabjit ask his question.
Do you want to unmute him? Now that I'm not
yes,
there.
Please do. Please do. You're controlling it technically. Sarjeet, are you there?
Aaj bilkul. Yes.
Please ask your question to Tarek Fatah sahab. Unmute yourself, Sarjeet. You'll have to unmute yourself.
Yeah. Can you hear me now?
Yes, we can hear you.
Mera bada simple ja question hai. Pakistan aur Sindh mein agar apan soche ki agar India unko support kare aur wahan jaye. So jo bacche after partition wahan paida hue hain, do you think unme itni matlab no naturally uneducation to hai hi hai. They will be happy to support India.
I think they already support India.
The youngsters after partition wale jo hain
aur kahan se jo mar gaye wo to kar
nahi matlab jo partition ke baad wale jo
hain main aapko bata raha hu Pakistan is only Punjab and the UP Muslims who came and took over Sindh yaad rakhiye
okay.
Even Bhutto sahab ke jo father the wo Kathiyawad ke prime minister the
okay
You have to understand. His mother was Hindu. You have to understand that this area that is Pakistan, there was the Hindu and the Muslim were intertwined into villages living for hundreds of years. There was no concept of the other. My family comes from old city Lahore, where I, in my childhood, I've seen the burnt houses and all that. My mother's best friends were, there was in class, she did her matric, I think in 44 or 45. She always talked of the friends that she lost, died, or they disappeared, or went with the parents and never to be found. But they were all from old Lahore. So the issue in Sindh and Balochistan is that while Punjab embraced Urdu, Sindh and Balochistan rejected it, just like the Bengalis did. And the International Mother Tongue Language Day is to commemorate the January 8th killing by Pakistan military of Bengalis in Dhaka, who said our mother tongue is not Urdu, it is Bangla. So language is a great determinant of a nation and a nationality. Punjabi Muslims, out of the inferiority complex, embraced Urdu, and Sindhis and Baloch and the Pashtuns rejected it. So this is very significant.
They follow their culture.
Yes.
They follow their.
Bacha Khan is still one of the most respected people in among the Pashtuns and the Afghans.
Right. So there might be a question from Rishi, the person who organized this. So
okay.
Rishi, are you there? If you're there, please come in.
Hello, Tarek Saab. How are you? Can you see me now?
Yes, I can see you, sir.
Thank you so much. So what I wanted to know is that after this independence, now whatever the case is that is there in India today, we find ourselves at a juncture where if we do not take strong stands, which would be misconstrued or construed, whatever, as extreme right, then we might be, you know, losing the whole plot, because at the end of the day, Qatar is financing the Muslim Islamic radicalism in India, and the money is also coming from Turkey.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, Saudi Arabian individuals are doing that. Now, yes. How do you go about it? There has to be a counter narrative built. At the same time, you know, you have a lot of violence that is going ahead. You know, when what we saw in CAA protests. Mm-hmm. And what we saw in CAA protests over there in Delhi. So, yes. I do not see that, you know, an answer when we are being put on a gunpoint could be, you know, a very sane one, or could be even like Gandhi. No, it cannot be, because these people never understood that. They still haven't been able to understand that, you know, Hindus and them, we could have lived peacefully, because they don't want to live peacefully. That is a pure, simple and a very blunt answer to that. What are your viewpoints on this?
I agree with you, and the conundrum that Indians face from the majority community. My only suggestion that comes to my mind is the building up of an Indian Muslim front that takes this on. This has to be a debate among Muslims as to who they are. As long as the leadership can blackmail vote banks and act as if they are speakers, representatives of the Muslim community, you will not find a solution. So the challenge is among the young men and women who are Muslims to find them and to help them fight this, do that, to create institutions where a Muslim appreciation of Hindu civilization, of even the understanding of what is Hindutva to stop demonizing Savarkar as a demon, you know, that came around, to understand people in the circumstances they lived in, and to encapsulate the fact that when it came to fighting the British, the Hindu community was solidly behind saving a Mughal emperor. But it was not viewed in the sense of cooperation that it should have been. So unless this leadership to counter the radical Islamic extremism in India is led by Muslims, it will not succeed. How to do it can be very easily done. But my feeling is that India is overweighed by civil service that cannot move fast to adapt it. I don't think they see it as a danger. I feel meeting Indian diplomats, I feel that there is a concept of retirement. You know, you've done now, you will retire in a house and this is how it will be. People are not devoting their entire lives to India. It is a job for them. Jab tak dil se wo aag nahi niklegi, ki mere Hindustan ke saath kya ho raha hai, kaisi civilization. Matlab, wo jazba hatred se nahi aana chahiye. Wo right wing ho jata hai. Aur ek main aur aapko batau. Right wing ki taraf se jo initiative aaya hai, wo duniya bhar mein failure mein gaya hai. Wo kyun? Wo aurton ke khilaf, wo abortion ke khilaf, wo rights for colored people ke khilaf, wo har immigration ke khilaf. Aap dekhiyega ki right wing chhap jis pe pad jati hai, wo phir apne aap ko legitimize nahi kar sakta. कि मैं रैशनल बात सही बात कर रहा हूं इंसानियत के लिए, अपने हिंदू या मुसलमान होने के लिए नहीं कह रहा. मैं कह रहा हूं कि एक इतने बड़ी कम्युनिटी जिसमें 400 ज़बानें, 29 स्टेट्स, इतना कॉम्प्लेक्स कंट्री तो दुनिया में नहीं है, कभी रहा ही नहीं. उसको लिए थोड़ा सा ये जो मुसलमानों का one-sided view hai, uske liye India or Indian institutions will have to create not some Muslim RSS, jaise maine dekha kuch mere dost, there is an RSS Muslim group. No, it should be independent on its own. It should be led by Muslims who find the country comes first, the civilization comes before anything else. Kyunki agar Hind nahi hai to hum bhi nahi hai, hai na?
That is the RSS view, sir. Why should this not be led, this amalgamation that we are hinting at, not be led by RSS?
It cannot be.
It's the most eminently suited.
Suited, but it is seen in the Muslim mind as anti-Muslim.
But
they are not anti-Muslim.
Yes,
sir, Muslimano ke andar. This is the feeling. ये जो गाली बन गई है, अरे तू तो आरएसएस का है. This is a curse thrown at people. अच्छा, point is कि it should not just be, but it should seem to be as a pro-Indian Muslim formation to target the jihadis who essentially are Pakistanis. I always say there are more Pakistanis who live in India than there are in Pakistan. Because in essence, if everything that you say is the same as what you demanded in Lucknow and Delhi and Orissa and Bihar and Patna during the 1946 to 47 days. Ek main aapko choti si baat batau. You know, in Calcutta, there is no memorial to the August 16, 1946 martyrs. We've become such, what's the word? Pussycat? Nahi, matlab, Why? Thousands were killed that day in direct action day by Muhammad Ali Jinnah. And Calcutta has no memorial to that.
That person called Suravarti.
Haan, wo bhi Suravarti bhi thoda samajhdar tha. Ye to Jinnah ki pan-Islamism ne kaha na. Iske order pe kiya na. Gunde ko kaha ke maro. Aur maro Bihariyon ko. This is very interesting. Ke jab Bengal, Calcutta se dead bodies Bihar jayengi, to wo phir Muslimano ko marenge, to Pakistan banega. But Mumbai mein, jahan pe attack hua, aage kai so Indian mar gaye. You know, you have no memorial for that. Aur wo Taj Hotel jo hai, jahan pe attack hua, unhone इतना छुपाया है उसको कि नेक शगुन नहीं है और नजर लग जाएगी पता नहीं किस दुनिया में रहते हैं इंडियन भी मेरे दोस्त वो स्टेनलेस स्टील पे कार्व करके सबके डेड के नाम लिख के और उस पे वाटरफॉल डाल दिया जाके देखिएगा आप कि कोई देख ना सके सिर्फ वो लियोपोल्ड कैफे है जहां गोलियों के निशान उन्होंने प्रिजर्व करके रखे वरना ऐसा है कि आई नो नॉट इविल आई सी नॉट इविल करके The thing has disappeared. If you cannot react to the attack on Mumbai, what can you do? Kaghzi usme lage hue aapke ye proof dikhao to wo are proof ki kya baat hai you determine Pakistan is a state sponsor of terrorism shut down no trade wo dance jo aap log karte waga pe apne faujiyon ka mazak udate hain wo to band kare na अगर ऐसा ही बॉर्डर करना है तो किसी बांग्लादेश के बॉर्डर पे करिए जो आपका दोस्त मुल्क है व्हाई डू यू हैव टू इंडल्ज इन दिस बट अगेन द पॉइंट इज द अल्टीमेट सॉल्यूशन इज व्हेन देयर इज अ क्रिटिकल मास ऑफ मुस्लिम्स हु आर एंटी इस्लामिस्ट एंड दैट नीड्स आई नो ऑफ एटलीस्ट अ डजन मुस्लिम यंग मेन एंड वुमेन मोस्टली वुमेन हु आर clear in their in how they deal with these ab debates mein bhi dekhte the honge tv mein it is there's always some muslim woman who tackles the mullah right ek pe to thappad upad bhi kisi ko maar diya tha ek maulvi sahab ko wo abhi bhi police ke
pata nahi kaun thi lekin shazia ilmi ek aayi hai
yeah shazia ilmi hai aap dekhiye ambar zaidi hain ek ek wo I know many of these women
shah nawaz hussain
जी जी शाहनवाज हुसैन है साहब उनको लीडर बना दीजिए देखिए शाहनवाज हुसैन में क्लैरिटी है मुसलमान है प्रैक्टिसिंग एवरीथिंग व्हाट अ वंडरफुल मैन
यस
उनको तो कैबिनेट सब खोल के बोले आपका ये है आप महात्मा गांधी बने मुसलमानों के हम आके खुदा की कसम फ्री में बाकी जिंदगी रही है उनकी खिदमत करेंगे Because this is the call of the hour. This is not for Hindus to do. This is Muslims. You have to facilitate that jahan jahan log hain jo Hindustan se pyar karte hain aur jinko pata hai.
Shahnawaz that Amitabh just mentioned is actually BJP. I don't know why he has fallen out of favor. He is BJP. And he understands RSS better.
Yes.
So if Muslims join RSS en masse, there might be some internal reform in RSS as well.
Okay, let me put it. Why take a difficult task then when you can get it done easier? Take the path of least resistance. जो दरिया है वो जहां जगह मिलती वहां जाता है अब आप कहेंगे नहीं साहब आप पहले गंगा आ गया यहाँ प्रयागराज तक अब फिर से जाए पहाड़ियों में ऐसे तो नहीं हो सकता ना उसमें समुद्र की तरफ जाना है जो रास्ता है आसान जिसमें शाहनवाज हुसैन है जनरल अता हसनैन है बच्चियां हैं ये सब
एब्सोल्युटली
आई नो हिम वेरी वेल मेरे साथ अरे इन सबको इकट्ठा करने के लिए कोई इनिशिएटिव होना चाहिए ना मैं कहता हूँ इंडियन स्टेट की तरफ से हो एक प्लेटफॉर्म हो एक एक जैसे ORF है आपके यहाँ एक
There should be this thinking, sir.
This थिंक टैंक where it is a Muslim-led think tank, exclusively for Muslims. बोलो हम देखिए कि हमारा फ्यूचर क्या है ये 72 होने जाके दे दो पाकिस्तान को हमको नहीं चाहिए भैया हमारी एक बीवी हमारे लिए बहुत अच्छी है
there is a leader in India sorry
MS we got 6 minutes now I think they will have to put some finite kind of limit to though we would love to we would love to have you here and a lot of people have questions but I think sir
so if you want to take anybody's question just please unmute them and take it and then you can wind up
so there is a very young kid who's been chasing me from Gorakhpur he's calling me he's called you and he wants to ask a question so since he's a young mind I thought we give him make him jump the queue a little bit so
I have ignored the calls that have been coming in but anyway
okay yeah. Shubhamanyu I'm unmuting you here you go
so he's not from Scindia
No, okay. He's from Scindia. He's second generation Scindian. Achintya Lahiri's son. Okay.
Go on,
Shubhamanyu.
Good evening, sir. Big fan of you here. My question to you was that since 2014, maybe through election campaigning or propaganda, irrespective of party propositions, we have seen that there have been an absolute intermixing of ideological people historically. For example, people now keep Sri Bhagat Singh in the same category as Sri Savarkar or Golwalkar without knowing that Bhagat Singh ji was a communist as well as an atheist, whereas there were different ideologies to what Sri Golwalkar or Sri Savarkar believed in. Yes. So, is it because of a lack of historical education that people have created or is it because of the more propaganda-based driven media or social media or fake news which have been propagated to, you know, sort of mix everything in under one banner and push it in one row?
Okay, let me clarify that the Indian freedom struggle goes to many hundred years. And it culminates into the 20th century in which various strands of liberation follow. The Hindustan socialists, who by the way were Canadian and California based, had their own, what were they called? Ghadarites, kehte the unko. Ghadars, 1857.
The Ghadar Party.
Another party. They were different. The Communist Party had a major role to play in dismantling colonialism because the Second World War saw the decimation of the West as compared to the Red Army, which had about 2 million men in service and a great influence in liberating not just India, but Congo, you know, go to Mozambique, everywhere the left has been the central basis of fighting for freedom of occupied countries. Chahe Palestine ho, Kurdistan ho, Balochistan ho, anywhere where there's a liberation war, you will see that naturally it is the left that gets involved. The right usually also gets involved, but is more in taste with what Muhammad Ali Jinnah did, or some of the early Congress men, like people even like Aga Khan, who wanted India to become so enlarged by taking over East Africa so that Hindus would become a minority. You guys might not know this. But why should it be that this would be a problem? If Bhagat Singh and Savarkar are part of the same people, same India, that they took multiple paths. For example, Netaji ko aap lijiye, I have a serious difference of view of anyone who cooperated with Hitler. And that's what Netaji did. I salute him for his contribution to his struggle within the Congress. But he went to Mussolini and Hitler formed the Indian National Army in Europe.
but purely because those were opposing the British rule.
I understand, but this was a world war in which there was one wrong party and the rest of the world was fighting it. That was Nazi Aryan supremacy over the rest of the world. Then he abandoned the Indian National Army in Europe and through a submarine went to Madagascar, where he was transferred to a Japanese submarine, and then he led the Indian POWs from Singapore into the Indian National Army. Has anyone studied what happened to the Indian National Army, 5,000 soldiers in Holland, who were made to work for the Nazi army as enforcers? आपको पता है कि सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर खत्म होने के बाद उन हमारे हिंदुस्तानियों का क्या हशर हुआ स्विट्जरलैंड में? People said you came from India to work for Hitler and to attack the liberation fighters. जिसमें, if people don't recognize, there was one princess who gave her life. Noor Inayat Khan, born in Moscow, lived in French, occupied France, was a guerrilla fighter, was hanged to death in Dacha. We don't have a mention of her. But on the other side, now I'm talking from hindsight, Netaji did a great job in creating nationalism for India. But on the backs of Japanese, who slaughtered tens of thousands of Indians?
The British have acknowledged his role.
Sorry?
Netaji's role. The British have themselves acknowledged his role and that of the INA.
Yes, of course. I have family from the INA that who fought with him. The point is, what I'm saying is there are multiple angles through which you see. Yes. There are multiple people you see. I cannot discard Netaji. I cannot discard Savarkar. I cannot discard Bhagat Singh, because in the end, they all love to see their nation free from occupation. Sahi hai. तो फिर वो एक ही कमरे में अगर सब स्टैचूज हैं, इसमें परेशान ना हो आप. दे आर ऑल एक ही जहाज में बैठे, या कम्युनिस्ट भी है या फकीर भी हैं या सूफी भी बैठे हुए हैं. ये मुल्क है, इसीलिए हिंदुस्तान ऐसा मुल्क है जिसको बचाना है. पारसी है, सिख है, कमाल कर दिया साहब, कमाल कर दिया कि सारे ज़ोरास्ट्रियंस को पनाह दे दी और उसके बाद जो शिया है उनको भी पना दे
सर एक देयर इज अ ब्रदर फ्रॉम अनदर मदर हियर, हिज नेम इज ध्रुव सिंह चौहान एंड ही डज हैव अ क्वेश्चन एंड आई थिंक आई जस्ट ओपन हिज लाइन. चलो ध्रुव शुरू हो जाओ.
हां या सर नमस्कार, गुड टू सी यू एंड गुड टू हियर यू फॉर सच अ लॉन्ग टाइम. थैंक यू सो मच एंड इट्स अ ऑनर एंड प्लेजर टू हियर यू सो लॉन्ग. सर माय क्वेश्चन इज दैट India partition happened and more Muslims stayed back than probably went to Pakistan. And that thing which happened was all for the Dharm Nirpeksh Bharat, the India which was created. Mm-hmm. And the culture, you know, has always been like what you said, ki Muslimar aur Hindu kabhi alag alag nahi huye, hazaro saal ek saath rahe.
Ji, ji, ji.
Aur humne sir apne bachpan mein itne Musliman parivaron ke saath इतना घर देखा है कि अब जो सिचुएशंस है उसमें ऐसा लगता नहीं कि हर मुसलमान उस आंख से देखा जाए कि वो यू नो इंडिया को काटने के लिए लगा है या इंडिया को बांटने के लिए लगा है. सो द थॉट इज दैट वाज दैट डिसीजन राइट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एट दोस टाइम्स व्हेन दैट हैपेंड इन 1947 दैट मुस्लिम्स वर अलाउड टू स्टे बैक, दोस हु डोंट वांट टू गो टू पाकिस्तान कैन स्टे बैक.
लेट मी
द करंट सिनेरियो.
Let me answer that question. Muslims didn't stay back because they wanted to stay back.
Right.
Let me put this to you. Muslims stayed back after the Nehru Liaquat Act of 1951. You can only have so many people per day crossing the frontier. And trains were coming loaded every day till it was stopped by the Indians at the request of the Pakistanis. Let me explain what was happening. Aligarh universities from 1947 to 1952, every graduate that was educated at Indian with Indian money would go to Karachi and get a job till the Indians stopped that. With tens of thousands of Indian Muslims, especially Urdu-speaking Muslims, people from Kerala and Tamil Nadu and most of Bombay didn't come to Pakistan. There were packed trains that were coming in both directions to East Pakistan and to West Pakistan. What happened? That they all wanted to live in Sindh, Karachi, and others wanted to live in Dhaka, which is East Pakistan. So what happened? Sindhis in Sindh were told that your language is banned. By who? By the people coming from UP. They imposed Urdu on Sindh and then made Sindh disappear as a province. The Sindhi population in Sindh stood up in rebellion and said that this has to stop. The word was Bihari na Khappan. That was the slogan. We don't want these Biharis to come and live. Why? Because they were turning Sindhis into a minority in their own province. So Liaquat Ali Khan, not from Pakistan, somebody from Haryana, who never lived in Pakistan, either East Pakistan or West Pakistan, was primarily interested in setting up an Urdu-speaking state as his empire, also faced hell from East Pakistan, because these Biharis and UPIs were going in train loads and demanding that Urdu language be the language of East Pakistan. And the Bangla-speaking members of parliament in Pakistan were outraged that suddenly the country they demanded is not for them, but for the people who are coming from UP and Bihar. You still have those pockets in Mirpur and a place where about 1 million Biharis live and have their own United Nations protected state over there. So, and they wanted to topple Liaquat Ali's government if we didn't stop this immigration. It was Liaquat Ali requesting Jawaharlal Nehru, ke bhaiya meri jaan bachalo, ye traine rok do. And so the train stopped. It's not that the Indian Muslims didn't want to come to Pakistan. It was that the Indian state said, enough is enough. Bahut ho gaya. For the peace between India and Pakistan, the condition of Pakistanis was, we don't want any more Muslims. Do you know what they were doing there? They banished the language of Pakistanis by imposing Lucknow's Urdu on Pakistan. So they fought for Pakistan. The people of UP, Bihar, Hyderabad, Bhopal, and all that. This is where the Pakistan movement was fought. This is where 100% of the seats for Muslim minority, category, 100% of the seats of UP were won by Jinnah's Muslim League. 100% in Madras. 100% in Bombay. Frontier? No. It was Bacha Khan. Balochistan, a separate country. Sindh, Allah Bakhsh Sumro was a Congressite who was shot dead by a Muslim League guy. And through one vote, Sindh became part of Pakistan, not India. Punjab, which was the only place where Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs lived together, they had to slice it and cut it. No other place was cut. So for today's Indian Muslims to come out and say, "Arey, humne tay kiya hum Hindustan mein rahenge." Arey, bhaiya, nahi. Sabke sabke rishtedar wahan rehte hain. Trainen band ho gayi. Free jo chalti thi. This was free. If you wanted to go to Pakistan, train will take you free to Pakistan. So they stopped. And therefore, this lie that we didn't go, maybe some didn't go, but you tell me, what is the difference between Abul Kalam Azad and Muhammad Ali Jinnah when both think of themselves as part of the Ummah? They do not think of themselves as part of India.
Right, sir.
Okay, I think.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
तो सर अब आपको गाड़ी में थोड़ा तो पेट्रोल डालना पड़ेगा अपनी
क्योंकि मुझे मेरा फोन बज रहा है बीवी कह रही खाना बन
नहीं सर वो तो आपके लिए प्रायोरिटी है बॉस इज कॉलिंग यू एंड द बॉस हैज गिवन यू इंस्ट्रक्शन दैट आज चलो बहुत बहुत हो गया सम्मान अब होगा अपमान अगर नहीं माने आप तो सर हम सब की तरफ से and I'm sorry to those who came on your invitation since you extended through your tweet but we could not open the audience to them I tried to with IMS's help
could they hear
they could see you everything is there okay. I just didn't because in priority
they had some school. Questions which you got
okay.
So I popped questions. A few questions but I in priority our school guys came first and because they yes. had spent time Mentioned. To send question advance okay. So with that slight bit of apology to those who didn't get the chance.
I have one question.
Ji.
Where will I be able to see this?
So, sir, I've recorded this on my laptop. It's a 3-hour long recording. Okay. So I shall send you through WeTransfer the file. If you just want audio, I can send you. That's a lighter file.
No.
If you want the video with that, yes. So yeah. I will send it to you since you specifically asked I'll send it to you
okay.
Through Rishi since Rishi hamara sutradhar hai and thank you very much again I'm superseding IMS since he told me to get lost now I'm going to say thank you very much sir for making yourself available your passion your knowledge and your zest for explaining your point of view is unbelievable it kind of infectious I think we all carry some bit of unknown based opinion some bit of bias some bit of unbiased jo bhi hai but aaj is manch ke andar sir aap se jo suna wo acha laga is soch ke ki ye ki because it confirms our view it may even contradict our view but it's enlightening so thank you very much again
and
please take care and please be safe don't let anybody come near you okay Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Cheers, everyone. Thank you for joining.